Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 20th chapter. Here at Israel United in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
On this side of the room, these two sisters, for some reason, they think they're funny. I don't know who told them they're funny. This with this brother that sit next to them, they're not here because they're single, by the way. They're here, Israel. Listen, this is why they're here, right? So last night I was telling them,
are they single?
I don't think so. No, she's proving somebody.
Yeah.
And the other one,
the other one looked like a kid.
I think, but this one, I believe, is older than the other one.
She got a face like a kid face.
They kind of both do.
So innocent.
They're
so
innocent.
So innocent.
She look like she's 17 years old, the one with the hat. Is it me or she look like a kid?
Yeah, she does.
17, 18.
That's good, though. She look younger than.
Got a MAGA hat?
Oh, she's 25.
She got the MAGA hat on.
She got a MAGA
25.
Hat.
25.
Sis, pick up the mic. Sister, pick up the mic.
So, Israel, this is what's going on, right? So last night, I was saying that we trying to develop a show for...
Just say you're auditioning for a new show. That's it.
Okay, so they're here to audition for a new show, right? So now, I say I want somebody with
personality.
Personality.
Some charisma.
For some reason, these three think they got personalities. This brother right here.
Daniel got personality. I know that.
Daniel ain't got no damn personality.
Nah, he do. He crazy as all hell.
This brother ordered steamed broccoli at a wing restaurant. He ordered steamed broccoli.
Oh, he brave.
And, coleslaw.
What they even got a steamer at the wings place? What do you steam broccoli at a hot wing spot? You went to a Moab spot.
Daniel and Carmella together equals crazy. Extra crazy. Both of them together?
They're two opposite ends of the spectrum.
But the common factor is crazy.
Yeah.
It says
that's a common denominator.
It's the crazy spectrum, so you gotta get the crazy from both ends. pH crazy pH balance right in the middle. Right. Chaotic.
Sis, this is at the end.
What's their names?
That's what I'm about to ask. What is your name?
Ishay Shayu.
Yes. Ishay.
Sister Ishay.
I call Ishay.
Speak on the mic.
Ishay is the whole first name.
Ishay. Ishay.
Yes, sir.
What the hell Ishay Shayel mean?
Woman of valor.
Ooh. Oh, that's a good name. Ishay Shayel. Ishay Shayel.
Ishay 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 Bishop.
Ishay Ishay Ishay.
That's her name. Ishay Ishay Ishay.
And it means woman of God.
Woman of valor.
Oh, woman of valor. Oh, okay. Ishe Shael. Right. Well, praise.
Ishe Shael.
Yes, sir.
So I always thought it was just Ishe.
That's a short.
Oh, I've seen a
that's
short
a, that's
version.
That's a byword.
Oh.
How do you spell that, by the way?
E-C-H-E-T hyphen C-H-A-Y-I-L.
Like, ooh, shit.
Yeah. S-E-S-H-E-I-T?
Yep. E-C-H-E-T.
Oh,
E-T. Okay. Ishe. Yes. So the T is silent.
Yes.
So it's kind of like Creole. Like it's silent. So
she since you got talking to Mike, talking to Mike.
It's not Creole.
It's not Ishet. For Ichet is
something.
Ishe.
Shalom.
Yep. Good.
Ishe. Shea. You don't pronounce the T.
Ishe Shael.
It sounds like.
Ishe Shael.
It sounds like your name.
Shael.
My name?
Isn't your name Brune?
Oh, silent T, yeah.
Yeah, see? See?
But look, wait. I got some news, but I ain't going to bring it out now.
Isn't his name is Bruno?
No,
it's
Bruno. It's Israel deep.
Bruno Mars.
It's Bruno.
Israel deep. Israel.
Brunat. See, the T is silent on Levi's name right here, too.
It's no T on Israel. It's I-S-R-A-E-L.
No, T. But you're... Never mind.
He says
I'm going to spare you.
Okay. Ishe Shael.
Ishe.
I'm just going to call you Ishi.
Ishi. Ishe.
So, Ishe Shael, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
How long have you been with IURC?
About a year and a half.
A year and a half?
Yes.
Go ahead, Bishop. Ask the question.
So, what's your favorite scripture?
Philippians 2 and 2.
What does it say?
3.
Wait, let me get it. Go ahead.
You should be able to paraphrase.
You
should
be making something up.
You notice some of these sisters be making stuff up. What the hell?
Philippians 2 and 3. Scripture. 2 and 2.
Don't read it for us. Go ahead, tell us.
Do nothing through strife or vainglory.
Says that verse 2 or verse 3?
That's verse 3.
Okay. All right.
Philippians. Read it?
No, he didn't say read it.
No, they didn't read it.
Is that it? Anything else in the verse?
She said 2 and 3.
Let each other esteem each other better than yourselves.
Okay. All right.
Why that
all
verse? Right.
It's something that I meditate on a lot.
What part? I like the strife part or the do nothing through vainglory?
Both.
Okay.
Oh, so you be mean. You like payback.
No, it's just something to keep me straight. Like,
talk right into the mic, sis. Right into the mic.
It's just something to keep me, like, my mind. Like, if I'm going to say something, let it be.
Talk right into the mic, sis.
Like, if I'm going to say something that I want to be done sincerely.
Oh, so you like to talk back?
You funny. You funny, man.
Yeah, she like to talk back.
So what do you think about Candace Owens?
Candace Owens. Mm-hmm.
Don't worry. Be honest. It's okay.
Do you know who Candace Owens
speak
is?
Speak your mind, sis. Right.
Do you know who Candace Owens is?
I heard her on the show and stuff, but I don't really.
Okay.
Yeah. What about Cardi B?
Oh gosh, no! Like she's out of control.
Why?
Definitely.
How so?
She's not a role model. She just do what she nasty and vulgar, very vulgar.
Would you like to smack him side the head for the WAP video? No? Damn.
No.
I would.
Yeah.
What is wrong with you?
You should see that video.
So your sister, that's your sister, right? Y'all not twins. What's your name?
Abigail.
So what do you think about Candace Owens? Do you know who she is?
Yeah. She's trying, but she's a traitor. She made herself.
Okay. So what makes y'all think y'all could audition for Malachi's up and coming show? Let's start with Abigail. Go ahead, Abigail.
I think I speak well when I'm not under pressure.
Oh, you're under pressure now?
You're on the spot, huh? Right.
This is an interview.
I was about to say, it seems a little, maybe they warming up.
No, actually, I'm not good at interviews. I'm not going to lie. Like, I'm really bad at interviews, job interviews and specifically.
So how the hell you get money?
I got a job. You know, coronavirus is lowering standards
right now. Oh, damn.
They just letting anybody in.
What they do is check you with a thermometer. Ah, you good. Come on, you hired.
Yeah, you could get here. Yeah.
You got a pulse, you good.
Damn.
Damn, she said coronavirus lowering standards.
Oh my God.
So what did you try to say? Coronavirus should get you in this show.
That's the only reason you got a job.
She said it worked once.
Thank God for Corona.
Black people coming up off Corona, man. They getting jobs. They getting $10,000 checks.
Oh, believe me, Black people's not coming from Corona.
I mean, they dying
Black
like hell
dying
too.
Like crazy from Corona.
Don't care about niggas dying. They like, I got a $13,000 check. Run that SBA loan.
It's they run those up like crazy.
I like this check winning, bro. They don't care.
So, Abigail.
Yes, sir.
Is that a MAGA hat you got on?
No.
Make America Great Again.
Candace Owens.
Oh, it says Candace Owens?
It says Candace Owens on it?
It's a Coca-Cola hat.
Oh, Coca-Cola.
Make Coke great again.
This goes with the dress.
All right.
Well, alrighty then. Go ahead, Malachi.
So, well, you'll be hearing from us.
Don't call us.
Hey, man, hopefully y'all warm up, you know.
But wait a minute. Wait. You guys know this show's going to be live, right? You just said when you're under pressure, you don't talk much. You're going to be under pressure for 3 hours straight.
The pressure is coming from the table.
they feel intimidated.
Intimidated by who?
You. So when you get an interview, you know you got to show yourself like.
You got to sell yourself.
This ain't the platform to be scared. You got to show that you are personality. You have personality, and that you are fit for the job. So this is the time to do it. Let it all out.
Can I get a job description?
The job description?
Talk.
Be funny and have personality.
It's a live show. Yeah. And Deacon is looking for a sister to fit the qualification. Like, for example, you have to be funny. You have to have personality.
Right.
You can't be afraid of leadership. Because if you want to fit the show, you got to show yourself right now.
Deke, is that correct? Or is there anything else that
Jeroham is missing? He's right. It's a live show. When you're live in the air, you cannot be nervous.
Yeah. All right, so you got to speak your piece.
And I'm looking for a sister that's not going to be intimidated by, Deacon is here. I cannot say this. I cannot say that. No.
Be able to formulate a genuine opinion about whatever's going on.
What characteristics you feel like you possess that make you say I'm good for TV or whatever the case may be? Because it's one thing to be funny around your sister, your friends, but it's another thing when those cameras start rolling and you have to now show the people your personality.
Yeah. Yeah, sis.
Because
I think that was a little too much for her.
What made you even want to come up here and say, "Yo, I'm ready for the show"? Yeah, her mic's
into the mic.
Hey, her mic's not even on.
Carmella, I did what?
Switch mics.
Oh, it's your fault. It's always your damn fault, man. You always in the middle of this.
Go ahead, sis.
He keep the books going.
It's always you.
Carmella always keeps some shit going.
Go ahead, sis.
Officer Carmella, he made it sound interesting. My sister wanted to do it, so I thought it would be cool for us to do together, you know.
So y'all come as a package.
Y'all a package deal.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
So, Deke, you don't just get one. You got to take both of them.
You got to take two of them. Yeah.
That's what she just said.
It's a one-man thing, right?
Deke, this is a package deal, okay? You need two.
Okay, so what? Let's entertain it for a second. What do y'all bring as a team that the people are going to say, we want to see that every week?
We have good chemistry, you know.
Every week? Every day. It's a 5 days, 5 days
yes,
a week
sir.
Show.
Yes, sir.
Monday to Friday. You ready for that?
So what y'all
live,
got?
Live television.
Job description.
What's
including
what's
the job
description.
Have you ever seen a radio show?
I've listened to one.
Have you seen Steve Harvey's show? Have you seen like Ricky Smiley?
I've seen a Steve Harvey
Breakfast
show
Club,
before.
Hot 97, all of these shows. The same stuff that we like watching is what you're going to want to, you know, portray to the people. But that's biblically. The job description.
So I think, yeah, honestly, I don't want to do
honestly,
this
you wasn't being honest?
My, wait, Shay, without.
It's a deacon.
It is a package deal. So I'm counting on the chemistry here.
Right. I haven't seen the chemistry yet.
Maybe there's some sort of synergy.
Maybe I'm missing something here.
What type of
have you seen the chemistry yet?
This morning.
Who's in charge
ask
of the hiring process?
That's the people online.
Hey. Hey, brothers and sisters online.
Yeah.
Have you seen a comment? Okay, some of you are only, some of you been here since 10 o'clock when the show start. Have you seen a chemistry yet? I haven't seen nothing yet. Please, let me know.
Hey, who's in charge?
Have you seen chemistry between these two sisters?
Be scared. Don't be scared.
They don't be scared. Nervous. Yes or no?
Who's in charge of the hiring process? Yeah. That's what I want to know.
We ain't hired nobody. Who's the fire?
Yeah.
Hey, we ain't hired
who's
nobody.
The talent scout?
Yeah, the one who's give that charisma. It's you are. Her.
Somebody say I like them.
Started.
So what they're kind of saying is they bounce.
Well, Israel say I like them.
They bounce off of each other.
That's literally what they told me. They were like, we bounce off each other. You know, she throw it, I catch it, and I was like, all right, then D.
Hey, some sisters say they haven't seen no chemistry yet.
Okay, give us a funny moment that y'all have had, and y'all just.
Yeah, driving in the car.
Go ahead.
Driving in
give
the
us
car.
Give us a moment.
Driving in Sabbath class.
Where y'all had, and y'all, because I'm sure y'all remember moments y'all had with each other, right? Y'all grew up together. Give us a moment that y'all had, y'all laughed about.
Stay sweating.
I hate be funny. I hate that. They be like, Carmella, country ass gang, be funny. You're like, man, shut the hell up. You know? So right now, I know somebody say, be funny. You're like, it don't work like that. It don't.
Look. You can't give us a historical moment that was a funny moment?
Yeah, give us a historical moment.
Yeah.
Especially with your sister.
Somebody said learn how to
yo,
hold
her mic
first.
Ain't no good, man.
Yeah. So how about this?
Her mic ain't no good.
How about show one of the clips and let's see the three of them, how they...
In action. Yeah.
Interact
with the topics.
With the topics.
Yeah. All right.
Good face.
Yeah, you gotta see how to interact with the topics.
How about if we give Daniel a chance?
Oh, yeah, let's talk. Who's the other guy?
Okay.
Steamed broccoli, brother.
That mic works,
sir? Yes,
this
sir.
Brother ordered steamed broccoli so politely.
All right. Your guys said you're together, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
All right. I'm going to change your guys' name to TikTok.
TikTok.
Your guys look small. They look like to TikTok.
She talks wrong. TikTok.
You tick and talk? That's your name?
TikTok.
Tick and talk?
Tick and talk. Yeah.
They've been home playing with each other since they was three. They've been playing with each other for the longest. They think that.
So
TikTok with a hat.
Yeah.
And what about this guy?
I have no idea who the hell he is.
I can vouch that Daniel is crazy.
Hey, Daniel, who the hell are you?
Daniel is a weirdo, man.
Tell us who you are, bro.
Yeah. Introduce yourself to the people, Daniel.
Shalom, Israel. I am Soldier Daniel, Atlanta Camp. I talk like Esau, but I'm Jake.
He said I talk like Esau,
but I'm Jake.
Listen, this brother ordered steamed broccoli and coleslaw.
From the hood spot.
From the hooded spot you could possibly go to.
Deke, this is
so
the one
polite.
That says, pardon me, the other day.
He prayed.
The one that says, pardon me.
Pardon me.
So, Daniel, how long have you been with IUIC?
I've been with IUIC for 3 years.
By the way, you ain't live here. You don't live here.
I live in Alpharetta now.
No, I thought you moved back.
He moved back.
I moved back since Corona.
He just got stuck. That's another word.
So you came with the Corona? Or
I didn't come with the Corona.
You got quarantined?
I separated myself.
You quarantined?
Yes, sir.
Okay, where did you move to?
I moved to the British Virgin Islands.
Tortola, just Tortola.
Then you supposed to go to British Virgin Islands and build over there? Then that's what the goal was?
The goal was to build. But, you know,
okay,
Benji
what did you do when you get there?
We were building. We actually did really good. We had six brothers at one point. We were, you know, getting on track.
There's only like 30 brothers on the island, Deacon.
There was a discrepancy with a lot of pride. You know, Benji's very bugged out. So, you know.
No. Benji and Tortola's bugged out. Say it like that.
I'll be fair. Benji and Tortola is a little bugged out. So
thank you,
they were very prideful. You know, they were, you know.
Why is he talking like that?
Because that's how he talks.
That's Benji. That's why.
You need that articulate brother on your radio show. You need that articulate brother, you know? You one that can speak well. Yeah. The Queen's English.
What you trying to say?
Eloquent.
You know? Oh,
eloquent.
You see how he, snuck the king, the Queen English in there?
Right.
He wanted to talk like him.
All right, go ahead, Daniel.
So, yeah, basically, there are still people who, you know, believe, watch IUIC, follow IUIC, and they message me all the time on Facebook. We keep in contact.
But, so you ain't planning to go back over there?
I am planning on going back. I'm trying to build some residual income here. That way, when I go, I will, you know, have money coming residual. In to support my
He said it's hard to make money on a British Virgin Island without being on a tourist trap. So,
yes, it's slavery over there, actually. The minimum wage is like $6 an hour. But
damn!
A one-bedroom suite costs like $1,500 a month.
Wow.
Wow.
Sheesh. All right.
Tortola.
All right, so why are you on the show?
Well, I'm on the show because I'm hoping that Deacon will like my personality, like my sense of humor, and
like the way you keep bobbing your head.
The price
like
is
that.
Right.
Yeah. You're going to knock Kanai out. He keeps swinging that head around.
You're going to headbutt somebody, headbutt the sister beside you, bro.
Maybe if I act like a white guy, I'll get the job.
Hey, it's not that kind of
interview. He's not acting.
He's not acting. That is.
Okay, tell us something funny.
Make us laugh right now.
Daniel, you're a single brother or you married?
I'm single. Yes, sir.
He ain't ready, Bishop.
Hey, Deacon.
Oh, Deacon.
So I just got informed that the brother do magic.
He's oh, nice. He do witchcraft?
Oh, you witchcraft?
Like real legit magic.
Damn,
clarify. Is this true?
I don't do witchcraft. I don't do witchcraft. It's called sleight of hand.
You perform illusions?
Yes.
Let me make yourself disappear.
Go ahead. Let's see.
Just turn off the lights.
give us a joke.
I want to see a magic trick.
Is the phone ringing? Hey, what is? Somebody phone is ringing.
Yeah, it was.
It's a magic trick you could do right now?
Yeah, you got the coins?
I do have the coins, coincidentally.
Show us a magic trick, bro.
You'd like to see one for real?
Yeah, I asked you to show me a magic trick.
Okay, I'll show you.
Here.
Well, the brother slimmed it. He comes into brick stuff.
That's violent, Benjamin. You need that's a flag right
hey,
there.
Hey, this is way out the hood. He got finally. Music.
Brother got violence.
I finally get to showcase my talent.
Mama, we made it.
I got some theatrical music for my boy.
We made it.
All right, so this is just really quick. I don't know if you guys can.
You need somebody to hold the mic for you?
Use this. Nah, we just got a bunch of cameras.
Yeah. Just a bunch of cameras and microphones.
Okay.
So this is not magic. What you call it again?
It's called sleight of hand.
Sleight of hand.
Yeah,
turn the mic the other way.
Turn the mic the other way.
Sleight of hand.
Yeah, that's what he was doing instead of passing out camp flyers. He was just making them disappear, looking like he got rid of them.
No, I can't hear that. No, turn around.
Oh, you
turn
got his mic, you got his mic tilted.
Yeah, turn the mic.
Tilted the other
like
way.
That.
It doesn't work this way. No, it's the other way. It's the other way. He just got it tilted weird.
Yeah.
All the in.
Turn around.
Turn it. Yeah, that's it. Just
we need some new mics,
go ahead,
man.
Just
lean up.
All right. So the angles are a little weird. If you want me to show the camera first that way or show you first and then show them first.
Yeah.
Just do your thing, bro.
Okay.
Look at that camera. Do it to that camera.
So.
You behind him. You can see the
This is called a coin retention. So.
No, his trick.
Right here. So basically, I take this coin, right? This right here? All right. So basically, if I take this coin, right? And I just place it into my hand like that. And I give it a little squeeze. Actually disappears.
Woo, woo.
You a witch, bro.
Brother, good.
It's on that hand.
But it's never actually gone. It appears where you're not expecting it.
I know that one, man.
Hey, you better repent, bro.
Nah, bro. He dropped the coin. Bro. He dropped the coin in the other hand.
Suffer
before
not
he went
a witch
up,
to live, man. Suffer
hey,
not
bro.
A witch
slide
to
hand.
Live.
Kill him now. Repent, bro.
Kill him now. So we can remove all evil out of Israel. Just
don't wait till next day of atonement, bro. Go ahead and just do it now, bro.
See, I told you to take the choice of doing a joke instead of the witchcraft you just did there.
It's not a witchcraft. The coin was in his hand. Yeah, I see it in his hand.
This is what y'all thought about that magic trick.
It's a sleight of hand. That's not a magic trick, man. The coin
was almost
in his
got
hand.
Me.
She was blown away.
Yeah, she was, y'all was
yeah,
blown
he
away.
He almost got me. I ain't gonna lie.
Talking to the other mic. That mic, what's going on with that mic, man?
She says she want more magic.
The blood has put mic on the show that doesn't work.
But
what the hell is that?
Patient Saints off the rails.
You need a talker phone, man. You cannot make McDonald's without mic. You need a talker phone.
Oh?
A talker phone. That's not mic. No mic. Talker phone.
What is a taco phone?
This is a taco phone. You talk.
Yeah, hell is on with Barnabas, man.
They don't have this kind of stuff in
listen,
Jamaica.
Benji, don't deal with
y'all
mic.
Y'all gonna try with the mic again.
We don't deal with mic. We deal with taco phone. You know?
Dang.
Is that a real
I don't
thing?
Hear you.
A taco phone?
Give him back them. Leave them. They'll share that mic.
That's a taco phone.
Yeah.
The taco phone.
That yeah. Where you talk to. You're talking.
You talk in it.
You talk in a taco phone. All right,
Daniel. That was kind of different.
Kidon. Because I'm gonna go along with the show. So I'm gonna leave the show open with you three of your guys.
When you're ready.
So your guys can actually
jump in when you're
jump in the show. Oh yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Because I wanna be fair.
Yeah.
I'm a fair man.
He read what he don't so trust.
I'm gonna be fair.
You a fear judge, D.
Hey, Kidon.
You're hard, man.
Kidon, what is that? No. The other one. Yeah. What did he say? Put that up.
Taco phone.
I drop off some liquor in their town and some guns. And
can you start the, can you start it from the beginning, please? What he said?
Every weekend, please turn it up more.
Yeah, right there.
Drop off some liquor in their town and some guns, and they do it themselves. Every weekend, I would go up to Chicago with a big truck full of whiskey and crack, marijuana, and a ton of guns and bullets, and tell them have at it and just drop it off right in the middle of town. And then go home and watch my Monday morning news and laugh the whole time. The Klan ain't got to go out and kill blacks no more. We just drop off some liquor in their town and some guns, and they do it themselves. Every weekend, I would go up to Chicago with a big truck full of whiskey and crack, marijuana, and a ton of guns and bullets, and tell them have at it and just drop it off right in the middle of town.
So
and then go home and watch my Monday morning news and laugh the whole time.
So basically what he's saying is, he said the KKK don't have to kill the blacks no more. They don't have to burn cross on your yard no more. He said that your guys doing it for them.
Right.
All he have to do is drop some drugs, guns. Because you ever wondering, you look at all this killing in the black community, right? But the Negroes don't produce no weapon.
None.
We don't make no weapon in the black. So you got to ask yourself where these weapons come from.
Right.
And some of them is like some really, really big guns. Some of these weapons is like $5,000-$6,000 weapon.
Yeah.
The Negroes cannot afford that. So you got to ask yourself where they got the money to buy these guns, where these guns come from. That's what he's saying. Hey. He's saying, listen, we just drop a truckload of guns in the black community with crack. Because we already know, during the Black Panthers, they was doing that.
Right.
Dropping crack in the black neighborhood, liquor. And we just do their job for them. The killing, they just do their job for them. As a matter of fact, I hate to say it, but
it's a pretty good plan.
We actually kill more of each other than they kill us. Than the KKK kill us.
Right. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it was a damn good system.
It is. When you look at a street like a city like Chicago, the murder rate is sky high. I mean, you're talking about 600-700 a year.
Right.
A year, that's just one major city.
Hey, Deke, and that's also how you know that this the fight is not a physical fight, because if mentally we were sound, we would know, yo, drugs, liquor, all that coming out community, we like, yo, what's going
like,
on?
Like, just leave it there. Like,
yeah,
it's a box of drugs and guns. They'd be like, ooh.
Our people wicked as hell, you know, so somebody probably found that. Now, that's a come up for him. He wanted to flip that, sell it to the community.
Yep.
Somebody got murdered behind that. He absolutely right.
And officer, too. You know what I thought about that video?
What?
What you thought, Abigail?
You.
I don't know. I couldn't hear it, you know?
Oh, they got no headphones. They can't hear it. Damn.
Hey. Oh, they don't have no headphone. Well, what's wrong with Elisha? Look at Elisha looking at me. Well, where is their headphone, man? They're here for an interview, bro.
Give him a can and a string.
It's an unfair battle.
What the hell is going on?
It's an uphill battle for a Deeks.
Hey, wait a minute, man. Give him the damn headphone, man. What the hell is
Daniel,
this?
Yeah, Daniel, give him the
play the video again for them.
Play it again.
No. Kanai, give her your headphone.
I don't know if it's touching that
He's not stretching that far?
Hey, Kadon, okay. I sent something to you. Kadon,
play the video again for them.
Awesome.
She was about to make a comment. I want to hear what she had to say. Everybody online was interested in what she had to say.
I haul some liquor in their town and some guns, and they do it themselves. Every weekend, I would go up to Chicago with a big truck full of whiskey and crack, marijuana, and a ton of guns and bullets and tell them, have at it, and just drop it off right in the middle of town. And then go home and watch my Monday morning news and laugh the whole time.
So he bringing out the truth on what happened, like what the government been bringing, been doing since way before this, time. So
why you got a purple and gold garment? That's what I don't know. You know, that's
your purple Caparotti.
Yeah. You know they're gonna say IUIC, IUIC funded them or something crazy.
What the hell is this?
No, that's gonna be the next
IUIC working with the KKK.
They were the KKK. Look, they were the same colors as the Grand Wizards.
Well, like, you know, Deke is a hater. He does hate Judah. You know he just got to be hating the tribe. He only like Levi. IUIC, he don't like nobody else.
IUIC in white face.
What does it have to do with this? With this?
IUIC in white face.
With gold.
That's not real purple.
Oh.
That's we not got real purple.
No, that's not real purple. We got
this violet.
And besides, he got purple on red. We got purple on gold.
Why Officer Malik got look like he worked at a call center, though? He got it.
So we ain't got no headphones because he got them.
Hey, Malachi is supposed to make sure all of us got water. Look at Asa. Asa sit here. He come here just to eat our food.
Yeah, he don't work.
Well, he cannot come in our show just to eat our food without trying to help us out. Can I have a bottle of water? Yo, he's hot as hell in here.
He said we got a phone call. Malachi, we got a phone call? Malachi.
This is a whole new
Malachi, we got a phone call? Did you screen the phone call? Huh?
Israel.
Then you're supposed to stand up. Then you're supposed, your job is supposed to stand up, not sitting down. Why are you sitting down today? Since you've been in this, since you've been high for this show, that's the first time I see you sitting down.
Call center vibes, D.
Oh, now you you put us a call center. All right, Malachi, put the phone call through. Oh, by the way, tic-tac.
Yeah.
Tic-tac. What you say make no damn sense. That's
hey, Shalom, call up.
Yeah, the white man been doing
Shalom,
that.
Shalom, call up. What's your name, question, or comment?
Yes, my name is Ari Ben Zion.
Shalom, brother.
When I seen that Ku Klux Klan on the television show y'all just the radio show you just showed, it reminded me of what I used to when I used to see at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning in the city where I live, where white guys used to come in with a truckload of guns and sell them to young boys as young as like 12, 14 and up. And I used to tell brothers and sisters that was selling drugs. I said, you know, they used to get together, and the white guys, the Ku Klux Klan, get together, and they talk about how they laugh about how they achieve their goal of not having to kill black people no more, but how they get them to kill themselves. I used to tell these to the drug dealers that's on the corner. I said, why do y'all have to kill each other the way y'all do? You know, it's bad enough that y'all committing genocides in your own community, but now you selling the dope and you're killing each other at the same time. So you just, you know, the white man's laugh about this every year annually.
That is true.
And so I used to tell them about this, but you know, for over 40 years. You know, this is the same crap every time, you know, when I go out and try to teach them better, you know, that's way before I came into the truth. And, you know, I just wanted this way before I came into the truth. I've been hip to this for over 40 years now.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. All praises. Thank you for your comment, brother.
Thank you.
Y'all think the KKK gets sponsorship?
You know what this reminds me of, Deacon? Do you remember the movie Tales from the Hood?
Yeah.
Where the brother, I want to play that clip real quick, Officer Kadon, where Crazy K was in jail.
Are they going to shut the stream down?
Probably.
Damn, he might shut it down. All right, never mind. But if you remember the movie, Tales from the Hood, they made a, what do you call it? when it, a scenario where the KKK dude is talking to the brother in jail and telling him, hey, man, we ain't got to do nothing no more. All we got to do, we on cruise control. You niggas on cruise control. You busy killing each other, doing all kinds of evil. All we do is provide you the means for y'all to do it. That's it. And the lust to kill is so embedded in you that we don't have to do it no more for you. Y'all on cruise control. That's it.
The hate we have for each other is unbelievable.
Yeah, that thing crazy.
So it's all, over the years, it's all built that hate, put that hate in us. Instead of hating them, now we're hating each other.
Right.
Because when you look, even today when you talk to the black man, you say, who's the enemy? He point to the next black man next to him.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's like that thing is embedded in our soul, in our spirit.
Indeed.
We killing each other for the fun of it.
But check it, D. I was pondering, meditating on this thing. Chinese people, we're not the only people here. We've got Chinese people, we got Arabs, you got white people, you got different nations here. But when it comes to our people, we're the only ones in this country that divide against each other. Mm-hmm. Whether it's east versus west, down south, neighborhood by neighborhood, block by block. We always divide. Why doesn't the Chinese man in this country do that? Or the Arabs in this country do that? But we always find ways to divide against each other. That's a slave mentality.
It is. Hey,
Cap, just yesterday at camp, the brother got knocked out.
Yeah.
Which play his own brother. You know what I'm saying? Knocked out. Brother knocked out Cole. He want to do more. He want to stomp him out.
He did stomp him out.
Can we see the video? Can we see the video?
He pulled his shoes off, frisbeed his shoes.
Can we see the video?
Put that video up.
Officer, you got it?
But the last insult with that was the people that was around began to steal his stuff after he was knocked out.
Wow. Yeah, we should play it.
So they stole his stuff. Like, after all of that, they still thought it was all fun and games, stole his stuff, and ran off laughing.
And guess what? I think Cap said that's one of our scoffers. The dude is a major scoffer.
Yeah.
But it's not like we glory in seeing him get his ass whooped like that. That thing hurt. He could have got murdered out there.
Yeah, we'd rather see him repent. We don't go out there because we want to see something bad happen to our people. Wow. But like you said, it's crazy how we'll do our own people. But the white man could walk through our communities clean and not have to worry about even getting touched, robbed, and none of that.
Guess what? So yesterday, a sister shared with me some papers out of a book called Treaties of Slavery. It was some book from the Library of Congress that something she printed out. But in it, it was going into what leadership bring out all the time as how we worship Esau. So in this book, it actually goes into how Esau replaced himself with God in each of the Ten Commandments. So that now, to this day, he put himself as God. So instead of worshiping the Lord, we worship Esau. He put himself as God. So he picked what the Sabbath day was for us. He put himself as God. So we honor him more than we honor our mother and father because he has put himself as the leader. Mm-hmm. So when it gets to thou shalt not kill,
that applies for us to him.
It only applies for us to him. Right, so when we think about doing good to God and being right in the eyes of God, we visualize Esau first.
You see white Jesus.
Yeah, and he did all of this during slavery. It was a whole programming to make sure that you understood that you blacks and Hispanics, that I rule this. Mm-hmm. I rule you. I show you what to do. I tell you what to do. And everything that pertains to God pertains to me first.
Right, right.
So, I mean,
if you look at, can I get a script real quick? Like, look at Ephesians 4 and 31. This right here is what we don't apply, like Officer said. We don't apply it towards each other right here. But we will enforce this when it comes to Esau and the other nations. We know how to forgive. We know how to not be wrathful with them and so forth. Watch this.
The book of Ephesians, chapter 4, verse 31.
And tell me this is not describing the hood, verse 31.
Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and
clamor
and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice.
So the scripture says Get rid of that bitterness. Get rid of the wrathful behavior we have one to another, the anger we have one to another, clamor, evil speaking of each other. Those things, we like to one-up on each other. Mm-hmm. We call it being a savage these days.
Savage.
We savage towards each other, but not towards the other nations. We good when it comes to them. We know how to behave and talk nice and clamor down and so forth when it comes to them. Read on.
Verse 32. And be ye kind one to another.
We don't know how to apply that with each other right there. We know nothing about that. Nothing at all. Go ahead.
Tenderhearted.
Tenderhearted.
Forgiving one another.
What?
Forgiving one another.
Where would the murder rate be if we forgave each other in the hood? Where would it be? Go ahead.
Even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you.
See that? Those are the things we don't know how to apply with each other.
Hey, right, but right. Cap.
Yes, sir.
You say, where would it be if we forgive each other? Mm-hmm. The first thing you would see is a lot of these jails would have been shut down.
Right.
That's the first thing. You would not, the police would not have a job.
So you're saying black people should boycott the jails?
No. That's not what I'm
saying. Well, they should boycott the jails.
That's a good way to do it.
Yeah, good way to say it.
Boycott the jail by committing less crime.
Well, actually, you might be into something. Instead of defund the police, why don't they defund the jail system?
Boycott crime.
Right.
Yeah. Defund the. You talk about defund the police.
So D, what you're saying is, by us not following this and being in the jail system, you are preyed upon.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
They're making big money, billions and trillions of dollars off of you by your sin.
Right. Yeah.
At least you would expose Esau if that's the case, because if it's a whole lot of unjust arrest, if you ain't giving them no ammo,
right,
then you got to be like, this is you.
But Kamalai, the system, the criminal justice system, the American system was built around Jake.
Right. I get it. Yeah.
When you look at, for example, even the clothes we wear, when you, for example, if you ever go to Manhattan, you go to Fifth Avenue, or you go to Madison Avenue in Manhattan, you look at a sweater, it's for like $5,000, $10,000. Black people don't wear this garbage.
Right.
It's the rich white men. So when you come to our neighborhood, it's two different things. You know,
two different worlds.
I just could just say we are two different people.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But now come back to the Esau criminal system. The criminal system was built around us, mm-hmm. around Jake.
There would be no criminal system without us.
No, there would not.
Right.
There is no criminal system without the black man, right. Without black people in America, right. Or the Hispanic. Because even the jails they're built not to put white people in there.
Right.
It's the same. That's why there's a book called, it's a lady who wrote that book.
I know who you're talking about.
You know what I'm talking about, right?
I know what you're talking about.
So it's the same slavery all over again.
Yeah.
It's the same thing. Just like when you was in chain, it's the same thing. They just build it. They just make it different.
Yeah. You know what I was thinking about?
I'm going to go a little further. You said it will take away this prison system. But remember the two greatest law Christ gave us. Love God as you with all your heart, and the second is like unto the first. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. We probably would be that much closer to the kingdom just applying forgiveness of brother and love of your neighbor.
Absolutely.
So we'll not only bankrupt the prison system, we probably would be running the kingdom
right
now.
Absolutely. You're right. Mm-hmm. You're right.
Cap just
right.
brought out Adam.
You know what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah, I know the black book you're talking about. I read a little bit of the book. I'm gonna find it.
I don't know. Cap had brought out the Ephesians, and he said, you know what it say with clamor and the hateful, the bitterness and the anger. Before that brother got knocked out at camp yesterday, all of those things transpired before
the new Jim Crow,
the physical attack on the brother.
That word clamor goes into arguing, loud, boisterous arguing.
Right, bitch, right. That is exactly because it went on twice when we was at camp. So it was, and then the bystanders, you know, they egging it on. Oh yeah, he finna get his ass. And then it calmed down. And the only reason it calmed down because the rain started. Mm. So it's like always,
here's the video right there.
When the rain dried up and we came, and it started right back with the clamp, them arguing and going back and forth, and I do this to you, and blah. And before you know it, you got a whole crowd, and everybody is engulfed in all of this madness to where it went from arguing to damn near murder to death. You know what I'm saying? Like, wow. Like it was like a whole little, and when he just read that, like that was like almost like reading a play or something, or watching it, wow, you know, in your head. But
let's take a look at the video.
This is why, this is what the KKK guy was talking about. Play this. This has happened yesterday while we were there. Turn it down. Turn it down a little bit. More. More.
You see his head hitting on the ground?
Shit, that better be bad.
Yes. So this has happened yesterday while we were at the kid.
Frisbee his shoe. I guarantee you they was at Black Lives Matter rallies.
Right.
We all black.
Black lives don't matter then.
We all black. You see, look up. We all black, bro.
Hey, the brother was laid out for a couple, literally a couple hours. We had continued. He was dead till we left, right, Cap?
No, they had. No, he disappeared.
He just swing that baby.
That's the type of evil when the nations look at us. We don't look like anything.
No, he came back for more.
Wow.
And then they took his stuff.
Oh yeah, I just seen nigga knocked out. He ain't getting these back. I got shots.
You hear me?
He ain't getting these back.
Yeah, yeah.
It's why we need y'all. Because the black man, we hate each other. Y'all said we should not kill like that. Read it again. Thou shalt.
So, hey. This is what the KKK guy was talking about.
Mm-hmm.
They hate. The hate we have, it's like that thing embedded in us, man.
Right. Mm-hmm. That slave thing, man.
That mentality.
Hey, this reminds me of a scripture. Can I pull it, Cap?
Yeah.
Jeremiah chapter 5, verse 26.
The book of Jeremiah chapter 5, what you said, verse 56?
Verse 26.
For among my people are found wicked men.
Mm-hmm.
They lay wait, as he hath set it snares, they set a trap, they catch men.
And that's what we see in our community, because our people ain't catching Esau.
Right.
They ain't knocking Esau out. How you got a whole prison full of Jake and a couple of Edomite guards, and the whole prison is quiet? They set traps for each other, and that's what we just saw in this video. This man, that brother could have got killed out there. And that's how people roll. They don't have no regard for each other. Right. When Christ come back, none of that's going down. You do that, off with your head.
You know it's crazy. So they 13th Amendment say slavery is abolished except for punishment for a crime, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
We was talking about it yesterday. Technically, so when the police get their hand on you, you are technically a slave again, and they can do anything they want to you. Time they get their hands on you.
Legally.
Mm-hmm. Legally. And I think that's why I was thinking like, damn, that's probably why we don't see nothing, because treatment of a slave is no penalty for it.
Yeah.
So if you get caught in the act of a crime or whatever, and the police get their hands on you, technically you are right back in slavery at mm-hmm. that moment.
And you know who helped push that? Joe Biden. The same one everybody going to go vote for.
Kamala Harris. Right.
Right. They help enforce those laws so our people can work in these prisons for free.
Right. They're giving them they're giving the California firefighters a dollar a day, $1 an hour.
The prisoners.
Yeah. Wow. They get like $1 a day to fight them 3 million acres of
fire
tornadoes.
Y'all gonna get burnt the hell up, nigga.
Perfect time to escape.
Damn. Yeah.
You might as well.
Be a nigga draws out there.
Hey, get that in Titus 3 and is it 2? Or Titus 3 and 3 about hateful.
Yeah, 3 and 3.
Yeah. That's what's going on. Now, was that bag that that dude picked up his bag or the other dude's bag?
That dude's bag.
It was stealing that.
Yeah. You hear him in the camera saying it.
Now, if the cops arrest the brother, Jake will get mad at the police. Leave him alone! But meanwhile, he just stomped out that dude for no good reason.
And when he go to jail, they're going to have t-shirts, free such and such.
Right.
Free big stomp.
Yeah.
You know, before you read that scripture, you know, so crazy, Bishop. We got mad when we see cops put one of these dudes to death. The scripture said the wicked shall not go unpunished. A lot of time, you don't know what that brother was into the night before that.
Right.
Why must I get put the spit on that cop?
To do what he did.
To did what he did to that dude.
Right. So it could have been some last week he did.
That's what
you
I'm saying.
Know.
So imagine a year from now, the Atlanta PD put that same dude to death. He was going to go march.
We going to go march.
Black Lives Matter. But they forgot a year ago, he was the same one who was stomping his own brothers.
They'd be like, say his name, Big Stomp. Say his name, Big Stomp. You know what I'm saying?
So he'd be the same one. People's going to go out there, march for him. Why the cop put him to death? But that was the same Negro who was stomping his own brothers last year.
And they hate the truth.
Yeah,
the one that got knocked out and the one that did the knocking out.
Like, people may say, why y'all ain't doing nothing? Why y'all ain't trying to stop or do anything? But God tell us not to meddle not in another man's business. So, like you said, that could be judgment of the Lord. Because we see him today, but a year from now, if he, God forbid, if he get put to death, again, people going to march for him, not remembering the damage and sin he did in the past.
What he did. Yeah. But go ahead with the scripture.
Book of Titus, chapter 3, verse 3. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful, and hating one another.
Hey, this scripture say it all.
Right.
Read that scripture again, man.
For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish.
Sometimes foolish. That's talking about before you come into truth.
Right.
Go ahead.
Disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lusts and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful, and hating one another.
Hateful, envy, murder, hating
like
one another.
Deceived. We deceived to think that we are each other's enemy. We all in the same situation, got put all in the ghettos of America, and we look at the next black man that's in the same situation as you as the damn enemy.
Right.
Meanwhile, Esau walk his poodle through your neighborhood with no problem.
Hey, but
gentrify your neighborhood, kick you out your house.
I believe we got a phone call too. You want to take the phone call?
Yeah, let's take the phone call and see what Kamala want to say something. I don't know what the hell you want to say.
Nothing.
What's up with these three?
Nothing.
You ready?
She about to choke
y'all
on
quiet?
Water.
Quiet.
Ready? Hey, Shalom caller, what's your name, question, or comment?
My name is Steve, and commenting on is about the Ku Klux Klan guy. The fact that,
say it again, brother.
My name is Steve, and I've been wanting to comment on the Ku Klux Klan guy.
Yes, sir.
And the thing is, there was a show out. I think it comes out this fall called Snowfall. I don't know if you guys ever seen that before.
Yes.
What it did is talked about how they found a young black guy in the community. They helped him to get drugs. He was working with a Jewish guy at first, but then what he did, he took over the whole thing. They helped keep this guy out of jail. They helped, get information to him, and they helped him to thrive. And I think he was the one that came up with crack out in California.
Mm.
Okay, but that series is going to be coming on later on this fall. But thing is, it was just showing how, the blacks and Latinos, they were, utilized to get drugs into the community, get everybody poisoned off the drugs, destroy the community, and then, they whisk out, and then they put all these people in jail. But the people that really contributed was the United States government that started the whole thing in the first place. Mm-hmm. Okay? And it reminds me also another show called American Made with Tom Cruise.
Right.
And how they were flying drugs into the America, putting it in Mississippi, and then distributing it throughout the United States. I mean, it was a...
That's the Iran...
These type of shows are...
Iran-Contra.
What you see, the epitome of what America does. The problem is that you look on Sunday morning, like I looked this morning, and you try and look at some of the preachers and what they're teaching and what they're telling our people. None of them talk about keeping the commandments. None of them talk about how do we get out of this situation. All they do, you just got to love your neighbor. Love, love, love. And I just can't understand how we keep falling in the same trap over and over and over again. I'm glad what y'all brothers do. Glad y'all bring out history and y'all show us what's actually going on behind the scenes.
Oh, please. Thank you, bro.
Hey,
Kidan.
Come on, what you was going to say?
I've got it.
Oh, God. Kidan. Find me what is Jim Crow mean?
Daniel, what you got to say about all this? I don't hear what damn you got to say.
Not a damn thing.
What you got to say, man?
First of all, the magnitude that Esau has gone to get our people where they are is astronomical, might I say first. This reminds me of a thing that we studied in school. I studied psychology. So you have two types of conditioning. You have operant and you have classical conditioning.
Repeat that again. You have what?
You have two types of conditioning.
Uh-huh.
And this is what the method that Esau uses when he trains his dolphins and his dogs and his pets. Basically,
the name of the condition.
What's the two names?
The two names.
You have operant and you have classical conditioning.
You say operant?
Operant.
Like operate.
Operant.
Operant and classical conditioning.
With an N.
Right.
Operant.
Oh, operant. Yes. Oh, okay.
Right. So basically, you take a subject, and they did this experiment where they banged a big, like, you know, Chinese symbol behind this baby's ear. And every time the baby would, like, try and play with a toy, they would bang this symbol. And essentially, when they took away the symbol, they took away the stimulus, which was the noise, when the baby saw the toy, he started crying. He got scared because he was like, that symbol is going to go off, but they already took it away. Right. It's the same thing that Esau has done with us. You know what I'm saying? They've put us in a situation where we see our own people, we see our own brothers. And if, you know, they saw that brotherly love on the plantation, they would whoop you. They would beat you. They would tar you. They would feather you. So now, you know, you go on the street, you see your brother, you know, you want to fight him. You want to stomp him out. Like, you know, Officer Kamala said, you know,
like. Mm. Yeah, that's that, right. Yeah, they would. And the other one was classical, was kind of like what they did with the dog. Training with food, put the food in front of him. He begin to salivate. He take the food. So after a while, he's trained to behave when he gets whatever stimulus he need. You know, and that's the same with our people. Everybody act right when stimulus check came out. You know, all of a sudden, you know how to act. Them folks say, look, we finna give you this money. You do this, you do that. They like, hey, we finna get in line. We gonna act straight. Y'all need to be cool. On the other end, you got to operate like what he said. Well, you give a negative stimulus. Mm. And that negative stimulus makes you behave a certain way because you don't want that thing to happen to you. Like you said, so rather than us showing love, like let's say for instance, Black Wall Street or whatever the black towns that was around, you saw all of them get destroyed. Therefore, we not try to do it no more. Like I'm not finna do that no more because
we
want to
go through that.
Right. I don't want to go through getting bombed and my people getting killed no more. So now you went through the operative training, conditioning. Right. Well, we destroyed your stuff. We destroyed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 15 black cities to the point now you have way more resources, way more privileges.
Still won't do nothing.
And you still won't do it.
That's like right. That's like the NFL, the NBA. Mm-hmm. They will never band together and start their own.
Because they've been classical trained. They got something good.
It's not in their DNA to do it.
That goes into the crafty council that went into making this the way it is. Because the Negro is an experiment here in America.
Right.
The Negro was created. Our minds weren't like that. Real quick, when you're reading the book, Babylon of Timbuktu, it talks about how we had engineers. We had architects,
metal workers, lawyers.
We had civilizations. Now right. We can't band together and put together two nickels.
A lotion stove. Be like, hey, wow.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, what you pointing out is on point because y'all saw that documentary, Contradiction?
No.
On Captain Shemaya had posted it. But it's basically this Jake brother's going and like, interviewing the black church, the leaders of the black church and the black church on our community. But the fact that during those times, right, that you speak about Black Wall Street and stuff like that, we owned 0.5% of the 1% of the nation's wealth. Today, we own the exact same percentage.
Right.
So that lets you know that they've kept us in this box. It's only so far you can go mentally. Mm.
Hey, you know, the video y'all just showed regarding Atlanta, that spirit... is get Exodus 2 real quick, 2 and 13 and 14. Because we might think it's the white man that caused us to fight one another. No, that's a cop-out. Is that the right term? That's a scapegoat.
Yes, sir.
Because look what happened in ancient Egypt.
The book of Exodus, chapter 2, verse 13. And when he went out the second day, behold, two men of the Hebrews strove together.
So two brothers was fighting each other, right?
And he said to him that did the wrong, Wherefore smitest thou thy fellow?
See that? And that's like people say, well, why didn't y'all stop the fight? Why don't y'all do something in IUIC? Go ahead. Watch what happens.
And he said, who made thee a prince and a judge right. over us?
See that?
Intendest thou to kill me as thou killedest the Egyptian? And Moses feared and said, surely this thing is known.
So the dude turned on Moses.
Right.
Right.
And that's if we got in the middle of that fight. Right. Right. I bet you online people would curse us out.
Right.
Why didn't y'all stop
it? Oh, that's what yeah.
They gonna curse us out anyway.
That's what I was about
just
to say.
Just because we was there.
Because Cap was just talking to the brother that you could hear yelling in the camera saying, we all black, we all. Mm-hmm. He was actually yelling at Captain Barnabas because Cap had just telling. He said, do you think that we're better than these brothers? We're trying to get them to repent to stop doing this stuff. You know, so the guy, he was going into all of this stuff. And then when the fight broke out, that's what he was saying. We all black. Why y'all ain't doing nothing? We all black together. And like, hell no, because when we was telling you to stop, when we telling you here, come listen and hear what God is saying that we got to do, right. It's, nah, y'all some weirdo ass. And, you know, we getting money over here. I got to feed my family, you know what I'm saying, and all this type of stuff.
Bruh.
And as soon as something happened, it's why y'all didn't help.
Like, so. You know how many fights that we would be in if we was to jump in every
right.
fight that
right.
happened at
right.
camp.
Especially
you
on that
know,
corner.
Listen.
Put your hand in the dog bowl.
Fights happen at camp in Atlanta on the usual. And I'm sure it's the same in other places, Philly, New York, and stuff like that. We would be a fighting camp if we was to jump into every situation.
Everybody's business.
Because you know what happens when you touch somebody that don't want to be touched. Bro, why you touching me? And then guess what? Now we in there tussling with brothers that we ain't have no issues with.
No, we're not right. there. Listen. We're not there to break up no fight. We're there to teach the gospel.
Right.
That's it.
We 15 brothers deep at camp, man. 20 brothers, and we go, they going to look at that like, oh, they trying to gang on somebody.
Hell yeah.
And then the streets going to rush in because, you know, the streets, they waiting for a reason to get in and kick them niggas.
Yeah. That's crazy.
And then that becomes your reputation as a right. body. And now we known as the camp that fights at camp. Now everybody that comes to us, they know that that spirit is a spirit
and
that they
what?
Can approach us with.
SPOC going to get a hold of that footage. ADL going to get a hold of that footage and say,
cut it
up and edit it. Right. Terrorists and cut it up, edit it real nice and say, oh, now look how violent they are.
See, right. we had a solution. The same people that are on there crying, stop, leave all lives matter, black lives matter, whatever they're saying. The solutions are right here. If they would just follow us in the Bible, they would be none of that. But they don't want to hear that.
You're a weirdo ass nigga. Be quiet.
Hey, right. Hold on. Jim Crow, the former practice of segregated
black
people in the U.S. So there's a book called The New Jim Crow by Michelle
Alexander, I think
no,
her name
no,
is.
No, no, no. Yeah, Michelle Alexander. It's called The New Jim Crow. Basically, it's talk about the jail system, how Esau created the jail system to lock our people away. Mm. The jail system is the new college. Mm-hmm.
Damn.
That's the black man college.
Sisters go to Esau College, and
yeah.
our college is jail.
He's jail. Jail. Yes.
Damn, what was that, Deke, what was that documentary called that the sister 13th. Put it? 13th Amendment, right?
They
went into all of that. That was a good documentary.
Yep. So let's go to the next video, because we spent too much time in that other one. No, not this one. Was it this one?
No.
That one.
Oh, right. Go back. Go back one. Oh, but this one?
No. The other one.
Yeah.
This one. Play this one first. How long is this?
7 minutes.
Okay, just play it.
I was on. I was on Fair in Adelaide. Coming inside the house, there was a maroon van. There is that maroon van, and the license plates are A-E-O-J-8-Z. There was a girl trying to jump out of the car, and she said that she was being kidnapped, and she was trying to jump out, and a man was pulling her back inside the car, and I chased them as far as I could so I can get the license plate. Woo, shit. There is a young girl, I don't know how old she is. She's in a car with a black man. He's in his 30s. She sounded young, but she
black
doesn't
man.
Have to necessarily be a child. She had braids going to the side of her head.
What a shame.
Oops.
What city did this take place in?
She said L.A.
L.A.
Oh, fuck.
This is the trauma we experience in our neighborhoods on a day-to-day.
It's a maroonish burgundy van. It's a young black girl in that van trying to get out. The license plates are A-E-O. Yes, I called the police already. Oh my God. I see posts all the time and it's like, check on your people or whatever the fuck, but for real, check on your people. I'm on, literally on the cross streets of Fair and Adelaide, like literally right here by the highway, right here by the park. Like they were coming down this street. He must have turned left. So I hopped in the car, brought my daughter in the house, hopped in the car, followed them, goddamn, like drove, sped to them. So I can get the license plate, because I couldn't get the license plate. It just happened so fast, I was kind of in shock. It wasn't, I knew she was, I heard what she said, but I didn't recognize what was going on until she fucking tried to hop out the car. Like, she was literally had the door open trying to hop out, and the man pulled her back inside and made her close her door. Like, see this with my own eyes, not playing. Me and my daughter, my seven-year-old daughter, just literally, like, witness this right now. It's a maroon van. It's a maroon van. The license plates are A-E-O-J-A-Z.
She's,
it's a black man.
Hey, stop.
He looks like he's no old.
Stop. She's traumatized, bro.
Right. Right.
This is the thing that our sisters have to go through, man, every day.
Well, God has a law on kidnapping. Get that in Deuteronomy 24/7. This is the law for you evil, black, ashy niggas out there, right, kidnapping our daughters. This is what, man, the Bible says.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 24 and verse 7. If a man be found stealing any of his brethren of the children of Israel and make it merchandise of him or selleth him, then that thief shall die. And thou shalt put evil away from among you.
That thing need to be enforced.
Yes, right, sir.
Yep.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Hey, and I'm...
you need, you know, death.
The scripture I should have pulled now, back in Jeremiah 5:26. Let's say the same thing. The same thing.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 5, verse 26. For among my people are found wicked men. They lay wait as he that setteth snares. They set a trap. They catch men.
So that's what our people do, and we do that to each other.
Right.
You ain't catching a little white kid.
Right.
We got a phone. We got a phone call. Go ahead, Malachi. Put him through.
You ready? Hey, Shalom caller. What's your name, question, or comment? Shalom caller. What's your name, question, or comment?
All right. I got a call. My name is Solomon, and I got a comment.
All right, what's your comment, brother?
I just wanted to quickly about this so-called police brutality versus so-called black-on-black crime, right? There's a site called Mapping Police Brutality. It says the police have...
Hey, I cannot... Hey, bro, I cannot... Bro, I cannot hear nothing you said.
Can you take us off speaker?
Oh, my bad. Can you hear me now?
All right, try again, brother.
All right, so I'm looking at a site called mappingpoliceviolence.org, and it shows that for the entire country, the police have killed 781 people, but only 28% of those is so-called black, which is like 203. So of course that's bad, right? Nobody's saying that's good. However, when I look at the tracking the crime in Chicago, this year alone, 310 black, not Hispanic, have been killed as of September 7th. So you brother just bringing out, we got to stop killing each other and always trying to blame the police and all of that. It's way more death by us not keeping that law, by loving our neighbors as ourselves. And so I just wanted to bring that out for the people.
Absolutely.
That's hating and angry.
Yep.
Yeah, the white man hate us, but we keep killing each other. We got to stop doing that. So,
hey, The law Bishop just read was not put in there for the white man.
Right.
The
right,
law
right.
Bishop just read in Deuteronomy. Was it Deuteronomy?
27.
Read that law again. That law is not for the white man. That law was for the evil, ashy black
and Hispanic.
Yes.
Deuteronomy chapter 24 and verse 7. If a man be found stealing any of his brethren.
You hear what it said? Any of his brethren. So that was talking about the Israelite. That's not talking about the other nations. Read.
If a man be found stealing any of his brethren of the children of Israel.
Of the children of Israel. That's the key right there. That law was put in place for the Israelite. Because we always have evil people in the midst of us. That is why Bishop said that law should come back. Listen. Sometimes you feel like having a drive-by.
Right. Spray the block.
You gonna throw up on people in the drive-by. Yo, like Bishop, I wanna win the
listen, I always say it. Listen, I love black people, Israelite, but I hate it.
Sound like Chris Rock.
Yes, I hate it. When you look at the book of Isaiah, when Mosagat was saying this, the prophet Isaiah said, in Isaiah chapter 1, right? It's a chapter 1, verse 4, right? That's not talking about when he said a sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoer.
Damn. We make up evil.
Yeah.
Our sperm is
children
evil.
That are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel into anger. They are gone away backward. That's us.
Right.
Listen, we become so evil, we become worse than the white man.
Yeah.
I'm telling you.
And that's scriptural too.
Yes. We are so evil, we become more evil than the enemy. That's our bad grip. Some of us, we in a path of no return. Some of us, you can tell, you say, yeah, yo, that's the tutu right there.
Hey, look at, you done with that, D?
Yeah, go ahead.
Look at Isaiah 22 and 14, just to back Deke up. He says, some of y'all are too far gone, right?
The book of Isaiah.
Watch this.
22 and verse
14.
Verse 14.
Let's see how you going to get right.
And it was revealed in mine ears by the Lord of hosts.
Uh-huh.
Surely this iniquity shall not be purged from you till you die.
Who said it?
The Lord of hosts.
Save the Lord of hosts. Some of y'all gotta go, man.
Some of y'all,
there's no return for you.
You see what that scripture is? This is the scripture when you see the cops shot one of us down. That's the scripture the pastor gotta read.
Right.
When they have those conference, they have, what you call them? Those
the Hebrew Israelite conference.
No. When they invite the family to talk to the press,
right?
They have a press conference.
Like the mayor open up the
press conference.
Yes. Instead of the family talking about, we forgive you. Yeah. No, right. Read that scripture right there.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 22, verse 14. And it was revealed in my ears by the Lord of hosts. Surely this iniquity shall not be purged from
you. You hear that thing? This iniquity is not going to be purged. That sin is not going to be purged into what?
Till you die.
Until the cop put you to death.
Die.
Could y'all imagine? Says the Lord God of hosts.
God said it. We didn't make that up.
Right.
That's the scripture that should read at the press conference.
Some of us just got to die.
Yes.
Right. What
read that scripture. You see that? I always say this. Why they never invite us to a press conference after you drop there?
Because you're going to go. Because you're going to go. I know you love that little n***s, but that n***s had to die. I'm glad Esau put a bullet in that little n***s.
Hey, look at Romans 13 and 4 to go with what Deke said again.
The book of Romans chapter 13 and verse 4. For he is the minister of God to thee for good.
That's talking about Esau, that them cops.
But if thou do that which is evil, be afraid.
See that? The scripture says be afraid when you're doing evil. You're breaking right. The laws of the land. Be afraid.
Hot breath in that ass.
Hey, I could get one to back you. Let me get Hosea 4:1.
Can I finish?
Oh, no, he ain't finished the verse.
He was done. My bad. I'm sorry.
Can you like back the mic?
Romans chapter 13, verse 4. For he is the minister of God to thee for good.
Uh-huh.
But if thou do that which is evil, be afraid.
You want to sell drugs to your people? You want to kidnap your people? The scripture says be afraid.
Yep.
Go ahead.
For he beareth not the sword in vain.
Uh-huh.
For he
that
is
sword is a gun today. Go ahead.
For he is the minister of God, A revenger to
a what?
A revenger.
Esau is a revenger. We can't legally take vengeance on you.
Right.
But guess who can? The damn white man.
Yep.
Right.
God could put the spirit on that white man to put you to death for your evil.
You know, when you
that you're doing your own people.
When you deal with missing persons, that's a specialty unit with the police. And when you defund the police, that's one of the units that gets put out. So when our sisters get kidnapped, ain't nobody gonna be looking for them.
Right. Nope. They love kidnappers love to hear that. Right. The kidnappers are excited.
Let me tell you what.
Like, defund the police. It's gonna be easy for
us. Listen, man. I hate to say it, man. We are some of the most dumbest people on the planet Earth.
We hate order.
You got crime skyrocketed in the black community, but you talking about defunded police.
Right.
What the hell is wrong with the Negro?
Want to do more crime.
Right.
They like, it's going to make it easier to get this money. This crime money is coming in. If they giving $20,000 for them for a body on the street.
Bro, let me tell you something, right? They're talking about they want to police themselves. Seriously, I'm going to be honest. I didn't go, you don't put me to no training. You give me a gun to police the neighborhood. I'm not going to arrest no Negroes. I'm just going to, you commit a crime, I'm going to just pop you. Bah.
Everybody.
I'm not going to arrest you.
Beat shooting everybody
because
in the ass.
Because some of these Negroes got to go.
See, that's why they
put in the description.
Bro, they just, listen. Some of our people is just, they are destroying our community.
Too far gone.
They're destroying our communities, bro.
Hey.
When we going to have, I can't wait for the day when our daughters can walk down the street without a nigga arresting her.
Right.
And you worrying.
And worrying about our daughters, our little sons walking down the street without catching a bullet. When is this going to end?
Hey, Deke, we are directly the cause of, because remember, like Cap just read in Romans 13, the powers that be, they're ordained of God. The Most High had to put this wicked man into place because what? He's his sword. So when we acting up, that's the reason why we need police in our neighborhoods doing what they're doing.
You do.
At the end of the day, what they doing to our people, is it right? No, but guess what? The Lord got that judgment upon us because of our wickedness. When you look at the things that go on in our community, like for instance, they just had the 2020 March on Washington, right? It was pretty much about police brutality and things like that, police reform. But what about the black community reform? What about us changing our mentality as a people? What about stop killing one another? Mm-hmm. We don't want to deal with the real solutions. We want to blame it on, it's the white man's fault. It's the same thing that a lot of our brothers in the Hebrew community do. Oh, it's the white man. It's the white man, because we don't want to hold the accountability of saying, listen, we messed up. You know what I'm saying? And we got to get ourselves right.
And remember New York back in the early 90s under Mayor Dinkins? Mm-hmm. We had a black mayor.
Yep.
We had a black chief of police.
Yep.
And crime skyrocketed. He pulled the cops out of the ghettos and all that. Crime went crazy in the early 90s. Crazy.
2,000 murders average a year in New York.
Yes. Wow. There was a time every morning in Brooklyn you wake up, you bodies. Find like 5-6 dead bodies. Every single morning. Every single, and you know who come and clean it up? Giuliani. Mm-hmm. Giuliani. Yeah. Under him, bro, listen, there was lacking Negroes up left and right, which deserve. But listen, people are mad when we said stop and frisk. When we say, listen, we're not against stop and frisk. Because listen, our people is evil.
Yeah.
Let's just admit it. People are mad when we say stuff like, listen, some of our people need to lock them up and throw away the damn key. It's the truth. Our people just evil, but nobody want to face the fact that, listen, the Negro is just evil. That's it.
Hey, the funny part is I quit. Once I started learning, I stopped feeling sorry for the violence. And I know people hate that, but then because you read it, we just read in Isaiah, we a sinful nation. We just read, we men stealers. Yeah. We just read, we didn't read it. Hosea said, there's no mercy with us. We bloodshedders. Yeah. We do all this. And we just read that Romans say that this man is the sword of God.
Right.
Guess what? You, and Bishop just said it, you might not have did what you did the day that he got you. That don't mean you ain't did some BS
right.
last week, mm-hmm, week right. before. I mean, you know what I'm saying? So now I be like, he had to do something, because the Lord ain't gonna just let Esau, like how it started out. It's not really Esau that's doing it. All of this is because we doing it.
Yes, but
Esau
hey,
will give you the
all
tools
your thoughts,
to
Solomon.
Do it.
Yes, sir. Hey, you want to, let me show you. We want to show how evil we are. Put the next video.
We
watch
got a
this.
Phone call
look at this. Put the next video.
Call up.
Look
call
at this.
Hold
I want you to line. Look at this. Look at this.
Wow.
He look white.
Walk up to the car.
That's disappointing.
And shoot two police officers. And then you got these niggas in front of the, went to the hospital. They're in front of the hospital where the cops is getting treatment.
Saying they hope they die.
They're saying that they hope they die.
And Esau going to take it out on your neighbor.
Let me tell you something, man.
You know, when I first saw this, I thought the cops that got shot were veteran cops and they did some evil in the neighborhood. But I found out these are rookie cops, been on the job a week.
Wow.
Just started.
Just started. And Jake went, pop, pop, bust them both in the head.
Now you see why cops be on edge when they go in our communities and they be ready to pull their gun because they show videos like that against the cops. They say, when you go in these neighborhoods, don't take it lightly. Because if you do, especially the Negro cops,
because
they like, that's my brother.
Yeah.
Don't think like that because now you're going in there thinking that's your brother. And as soon as you turn your back and let your guards down, you get bullets in your head.
Hey, about
you,
that
you know, you
movie.
Know, I don't want to, I want to clear this up also. We're not saying all cop, that's not, we're not saying all cop is a good cop. That's not
right,
what we're saying.
Right, no.
We're not talking about the cop. We're talking about our neighborhood, the Negro. Listen, because I know how some people are thinking right now. Oh, they're saying that it's
you're
okay
pro-cop.
For the cops to kill our people. That's not what we're saying. We are not saying that at all. Keep in mind, Negro, the law was not given to the white man. The law, every single law in this Bible was only given to one people, the so-called Negro, Hispanic, and Native American Indian. So what is that telling you? We was evil as hell.
Right.
That's what we're talking about. We are evil as hell because the law was given to us. Most of God give us the law, what to do, what not to do, how to behave, how to act around each other. So the law was not given to that nation. So we're talking about how evil our people are. We're not saying, oh, every cop is a good cop. No, that's not what we're saying. We're telling you how evil our people are, and yes, some of them deserve a bullet. I said it. Yes,
man. Did something.
Yeah, I believe.
Because
you
listen, you there we paint, you die. That's what it is, Bishop. Mm-hmm. You there we paint. You there we paint. Follow what the Bible said. But when a cop put a bullet in your head, no, I ain't feeling sorry for you. I'm sorry. I'm not.
I believe we got a phone call too.
No, hold on, Solomon.
Hey, I was just gonna say, Dick. You know where the mentality of us not holding each other accountable comes from? It comes from the Black church. Because in the documentary that I was telling y'all about, the brother made the point how the church teaches us to just solely be dependent upon a savior for everything. Mm-hmm. So it's taught us to be like, we can't go educate ourselves because we got to just depend on Jesus. Mm-hmm. We can't correct ourselves. We just put it all, the church teaches us to put it all in the hands of Jesus. Therefore, within our own selves, we don't push ourselves to do anything. We don't hold ourselves accountable to say, bro, you shouldn't be out here killing your people.
You can't judge.
But Christ said,
right,
the kingdom of heaven is within you. Mm-hmm. So it's up to us to get ourselves right, to prepare ourselves for the kingdom of heaven.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right.
That's all I was
going to
say.
You know, Bishop, you know what just come into mind? Right now, people's going to get me what I just said about some of our people deserve to die. When you look at, not Genesis, but Exodus, when Moses delivered us out of Egypt, we was in the wilderness. Moses said, I'll be right back. And we start doing no type of evil. When Moses come back, Moses say, listen, whoever on God's side, walk up to me. And Moses said, after they walk up to Moses, Moses say, okay, get your weapon. I want you to go and put all these evil to death.
Levi was ready for that.
Oh, hell yeah. It was a pleasure.
They was like, wife, get
there
the
was
soul.
There was a time, even after we become a nation, we most of God put us on our own land. Most of God put laws in place. Listen. Certain evil in Hindu, he have to go. He gotta go. Just like we just read about the kidnapping, about raping. Listen, you rape our daughters, back when we was righteous people, you got to go.
Got it.
And you would never hear somebody say, oh, why you gotta kill him? No, he got to go.
Yeah, because he gonna do it again.
And listen, I wish that law would be in place right now in the Black neighborhood.
Right.
Listen, if we put that law right now in the Black neighborhood, listen, 90% of the Negroes and anybody got to go. I'm just telling you straight. They got to go. Because why must I got to say they got to go? Because they are destroying the nation.
Yeah.
You cannot have, you cannot build a nation with these niggas around.
Hey, Giuliani had a debate with Eric, what's his name?
Eric Dyson.
Yes. And they were arguing about police brutality and crime in the ghetto. So Giuliani said, okay, how about this? We pull all the police out of black communities and you police yourselves. Eric Dyson got quiet. Now, he's never quiet. He always got something to say. Man, the whole audience got quiet. We don't want that. Because you need discipline. You need order. You know.
That goes back to that dependency upon the white man. Yeah. We feel like we don't have the power to do it ourselves. Because, I mean, the funny thing is we look at the white man as Jesus. So yeah. To him, in this kingdom right now, we say we can't do it without the white man. We can't police ourselves without the white man. We can't educate ourselves without the white man.
Now, we can. Most but definitely. Our people will turn on us. Tell
right,
them.
Right, right.
They will turn us, like just like they did to Moses.
Yeah.
They will turn on us.
Yes, they will.
What's crazy about this video is that our people don't understand that, like, when stuff like this happens and you see this stuff on, like, World Star and social media, now people start generalizing this to all black people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But then when you see Esau, you know, in his suit, you don't say, oh, that's the devil the Bible speaks of. You say, oh, I can trust him. You know, it's not generalized to them. So it's like, this is like something that kind of carries throughout the reputation of our community, our people. And then, you know, then you have that sinking feeling in your heart when the cops pull you over, you know. You ever played Mario Kart and you're like in first place about to cross the finish line, you get hit with the blue shell.
Yeah.
Everybody passes you, you know what I'm saying? Like, you literally generalize something like this to the whole community, but that's not actually how it is.
Hey, great analogy. I mean, I understood it 100%.
Hey, don't be surprised if they say that dude that shot them cops is Hebrew Israelites.
Yep.
Don't be
shocked. Right.
Don't be surprised.
Hey, Deke, you ain't asked the sisters about the trauma.
They supposed to chime in.
Because the sisters that did that video, that's
my y'all wearing MAGA hat. Y'all got
resonate. Chime in. The sister at the end is like she's falling asleep.
Like, I ain't scared of getting kidnapped.
Just talk.
I'm a Hebrew.
Tick tock.
Yeah. Tick. You got something to say?
What'd you think, Tick?
Make America great again.
I want to have some sympathy for them. Because, I mean, I think a little whooping, a little classic Atlanta beating, street beating, might help him. You know, y'all was there to put a little flyer in his pocket when he woke up.
He put a flyer on it in his drawer, in his
underwear,
in his pocket. Damn.
And that brother been out there scoffing.
Wait a minute. Are you talking about that brother that got knocked out?
That was an hour ago. What about the sister that was sort of kidnapping?
Sister?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stop. What can you say to the sisters so they won't end up in a situation like that woman just experienced?
What's going on?
That's Deeks, man.
Deeks,
man.
Red. No, it's
an audition.
Hey, man, you trying to get
put
fired?
He put the applications in. Oh, you firing now?
Bro, Deeks.
I done moved up since I've been gone.
Yeah, bro, you on thin ice, G. You know what
you say? You about to get fired,
who the phone call to?
Yeah, man.
Hey, Shalom caller. What's your name, question, or comment?
Hey, is Nichamai just walking here?
Shalom,
Hey, Shalom.
My name is Jasmine. And my comment is on how our people are just mutilating each other and terrorizing each other, killing each other, but they want for Esau to stop doing it.
Right.
When we do it, it's only letting Esau know you have even more of a reason to do it because we're doing it to ourselves. I personally witnessed somebody I watched grow up get his head blown off. I had this man blood on my hands. And there was over 15 minutes that someone in my neighborhood could have stopped this boy from dying. You got a phone call that somebody was looking for him, and it was supposed to be respect for the neighborhood. Let me call you before I do dirt in your neighborhood. You could have said, don't do that. Don't kill this brother. Talk to him. Handle it a different way. But you said, give me a minute. Let me go ahead and move. And you left, and it happened. But then you act like you care. And you hugging on this man's mom and going to memorial services and balloon releases, but you got that man blood on your hands too. Mm-hmm. And then you put me in danger. And our people don't care, but you want to be the first people out here screaming Black Lives Matter,
right.
Stop killing art, stop killing Ricky and JJ and Peanut. But you just shot Ray Ray last week.
Hey, sis.
And then went and hugged his mother.
Here's the message that Black Lives Matter puts out to our people. It tells, when you go and celebrate 4th of July,
and Thanksgiving and all these white holidays, what you're saying to the white man is nobody can kill a but each other. Because you can't kill black people. If you're a cop, if you're an Edomite, if you're a white man, you can't kill my people. I can only kill my own people. If black lives really mattered, we would look out for each other. The real Black Lives Matter, the people who really care about black lives, Israelite lives, Hispanic lives, is IUIC.
That's
because
right.
We're the ones out here fighting to stop the crime within our neighborhood. That's where it's all happening at.
And I like what the sis said about, you said that the brother was supposed to call some other brother from some other neighborhood before he do dirt in that neighborhood. Correct, sis?
The person who was beefing with the person who got murdered, he called the neighborhood. Someone that's supposed to be like the OG in the hood, he called him and basically was saying, I know he in your neighborhood. I'm on my way to do whatever I'm doing.
But,
and that person could have simply said, no. You could have also told that other person that they're looking for to leave. You could have done things to save this child's life. And then he was a child, 21 years old. He might look like a grown man in his 30s, but he's a baby.
And was he from that same neighborhood?
Yes.
Okay, he was from that same neighborhood. So, in other words, they have their gang set up and so forth. Their code of ethics and so forth. But it's all trash because when you go in another neighborhood, it's a different code. And it's, once again, we divide against each other.
And we don't follow our own code.
No.
Our people hate order. Esau will try to instill more order in our own communities than we do. That's why in Deuteronomy 4 and 5, when it says, and this shall be your wisdom and understanding in the sight of the nations, what it's saying is that when we keep the laws, they're going to look at us like, wow, but our people, we don't want to keep any laws. No. We don't want rules.
This is why we need God's laws. Somebody just said it's not the OG's fault at all. That's why we need God's laws.
Right.
And some of our people need death. They just do, man. They need death. They don't get it.
Hey, that's what I'm saying. You wondering why would Mosai God give a law? He said, these Negro got to go. He said, the elders at the gate, put his behind to death. Why would Mosai God push that? Yeah. Mosai God, no, listen, that evil Negro out here is no good.
And we some monkey see, monkey do type. So he got away with it. I'm finna get some too. Yeah. He got 20,000 for stealing a girl.
Listen, bro, seriously. Listen, seriously. If Esau take away the jail system, Esau apply the law, God law, the Negro come in the crime, put his band to death, I guarantee you the crime rate would have dropped. Boop. Guarantee.
Thank you for your call, sis.
When you go in a street like Chicago, if you put that law in the street of Chicago, you get caught because you got, bro, these niggas is killing kids. You put a law where, listen, you got caught, you've been proven guilty, put you behind death right there. I guarantee you the crime would have dropped.
You know what needs to happen too? It needs to be public.
Yep, exactly.
To make everybody got it. Like in third world countries, they do that. In India and so forth, you got caught raping a woman, they will whoop your ass in public. They publicly torture your behind.
Put a tire on you and set it on fire. You can't get it off.
We have prisons. That's in the scriptures. In Numbers 15, when that man committed sin, they put him in ward.
Yeah. Right.
And then they judged him in front of everybody.
Certain crime, there were cities you can run to.
Look at Exodus 21:12. This is about assault, which leads to murder. This is the law.
The book of Exodus, chapter 21, and verse 12.
Now, this is presumptuous, not in self-defense. Okay.
He that smiteth a man so that he die shall be surely put to death.
So like the video we saw with the brother stomping the guy's head in, if that brother died, this law says the brother that did it is to be put to death.
That's it.
Hey, ain't no fleeting, no refuge that's city. It. Ain't no refuge that, city.
Hey, you know another thing too. That's why you see, we always say a leader cannot be soft. A leader cannot be emotional. Mm-hmm. These men, these leaders, Moses picked to carry this out. They were not emotional. They were about God business, about God laws. Bring the forward. And I want everybody to stone him in front of me right there.
Right.
I'm telling you. That thing would have stopped crying. Why didn't he say?
He said, ain't no, maybe the kick wasn't supposed to.
No.
He stomped him. The man dead. Get the rocks.
Yes.
Right. And the next verse goes into if you are like protecting yourself or that wasn't your intent. Look at verse 13.
Verse 13. And if a man lie not in wait.
Meaning he wasn't, his plan was not to sit around and wait to kill the brother. This is the next point. Go ahead.
But God deliver him into his hand.
Mm-hmm. Meaning that he fought and beat the dude. Go ahead.
Then I will appoint thee a place whether he shall leap flee.
Right. Go ahead.
But if a man come presumptuously upon his neighbor.
That's verse 12 again. Go ahead.
To slay him with guile, thou shalt take him from mine altar that he may die.
Right. So God gives you two cases. Wow. One is you defending yourself. The other one, you was just a wicked.
Yes.
Right. You know what's crazy about this, Bishop? That Esau took these same laws and they instill it in their communities and they use the laws that were originally ours
right.
to police us and judge us. When if we would just apply this ourselves, mm-hmm. there would be no need for Esau to be telling us
and
this.
And that's why I exactly. said what I said earlier. The Lord gave us everything that Esau already incarcerated right. or killed us for. Bishop said it earlier. We do what God say, then we would eliminate their cause for they boycott the prison, so to speak. Mm-hmm. This is what we do. If we would do this, and what he just read, he said the Lord gave, see, because I know how niggas think. Say, oh, well, they just started fighting and he killed them. Nah, you went to that man in hatred. Because 12 say, if you smite him,
right.
that he die. You stomped that man in his head two times. Mm-hmm. It wasn't that you attacked him and he defended himself against you. No, you was the attacker. Okay, yeah, you didn't plan to fight him that day, but you didn't digress from the situation mm-hmm. to where it got to the point where even if you knocked him out in the street, you could have walked away.
Right.
But you decide to stomp him, take his shoes, throw it, drag him in the street. Cross. Guess what? If that man die, you get put to death, get the rocks.
Yeah.
It's going down.
Chuck him.
You know what you just read? What's so amazing about this? Let me tell you, the Bible is unbelievable. You know how when you go to Esau courthouse, you commit a crime, the judge about to sentence you, the judge got a book. He opened the book. He sentenced you based on what the book say.
Right.
It's the same thing with us. This is the law.
Yes.
So a Negro commit a crime, you say, okay, bring him forth, put him standing right here, and you find, okay, what did he do? Okay, find the law, you read it. Okay, he did this. He like you just like Kamala just described. Kamala is just like the prosecutor.
The prosecutor. Again, I want the rocks.
Kamala just sound like the prosecutor. And we read the scriptures. Okay, this is what Kamala just described. Yes, he guilty. Bring the rocks.
Bring the rocks.
The judge stand right here. The judge say, yeah, bring the rocks.
And when we kept this, we were the most civilized people.
Yeah, but we was.
We don't want nothing to do with this. So Esau says, okay, I'll take it.
But like you said, simply put, if we want to eliminate the belt, the same way when you was a kid, right, and you kept getting your ass whooped, you knew to eliminate this ass whooping, guess what? I got to start doing what my parents tell me to do.
That's right.
It's the same thing with God. Listen, we got to do what God told us to do if we want the belt to stop. That's it. That's the only way it's going. It's simple as that.
Hey, I believe we got a phone call.
Hey, I have to play that video from Captain Isaac. That thing is funny.
Oh, yeah, we got two videos.
Yeah.
Hey, Shalom, caller, what's your name, question, or comment?
Hey, Shalom, do the shit, Most High Christ bless.
Shalom. Most High Christ bless. Hey, you got a question or comment? Yeah. You got a question or comment?
My comment is in regard to... it's like a threefold thing, especially about the video that you brought up. The brother stomping out the brother at camp. I want to show just how deep that this goes. It's mentioned in Deuteronomy 28, how we have hate towards our brother. And I'm going to use some historical things in the past that shows that. And they portray that in movies, even if you watch the movie Roots. Or you watch the Django. When Esau, as the task manager, was beating the slaves into correction, they was beating the slaves into submission, pretty much. They always turned the whip to the next brother close to him. So that brother was more vicious than the taskmaster. I'm not sure if anyone saw this show that was on the air. It was called Underground. And they took it off the air. It showed like Frederick Douglass, and it had scenes of Harriet Tubman in there. There was a brother named Sambo. He was a slave. And they were working towards getting freedom papers. But when this brother got his chance and Esau told him to work for him, he became a slave runner. So he was catching his own people and turning them in for profit to get his own freedom papers. And it's that same spirit that a lot of our people had then is back on the earth now.
Yep.
Yes, sir.
That hatred is even deep.
Yes, sir. Thank you for your comment, brother.
Thank you. Hey, give me the Dallas Challenge video, bro.
Hey, Dallas in the building.
Dallas have an
exclusive?
They got the best
exclusive.
One, right?
Dallas got the best payback video.
Benjavites? Yeah, y'all fall back.
Dallas got the best payback video.
Cap. I'm going with Dallas right now.
You're
going to
denounce
man.
Your own
I'm going
for
Dallas. Right now.
This is Dallas.
Right Shout out here. To Captain Isaac.
Hey, Captain Isaac, we love you, bro.
You all right,
bro, I didn't know Dallas got it that good, bro.
So I know you had it in you, my boy.
Bro, you the best, bro. Put the video. This is close. Put the video up, man. Dallas got the best video, bro.
Sisters, we're going to be looking for y'all comments after the video.
Yo, let's see this hot fire.
Let's see the hot fire.
I'm just an ex-employee who's come for his back pay.
Turn it up, man.
Or should I say payback?
Payback! Oh, that's right, y'all. This is a payback! Flame zone vibes, flame zone T-mine. Oh, no. Nambla, put the candy down.
Let the little boy go.
Meritorious menu mission, act for free.
Wartime.
It's all you getting back from me.
My good deeds.
Lucifer bleeds. He's feed, green steeds, and feed on the zombies. On American weed. Tel Aviv. Big bastards of bastards.
Yo, that, I didn't know they do it like that out there, man.
They ain't got no gun. They ain't got no heart. They ain't got no power. But they got
the same brother three times.
That's the same brother.
In the dark. Oh. Why he look like he not rapping the words, though?
We the prophets of God. Suspiciously imagine your
head. Yo, Dallas on fire, you know what I'm saying?
D-Town.
The day to pay back, no
Then the Messiah with the cameo.
Oh, they got Isaac, right there. They got Isaac, they got Isaac. Nigga,
we be watching chariots. Is Captain Isaac co-sign this?
Friends turn to foes. His brother got a green screen.
Meaning the transgender. Cross-dragon. Books get closed.
Ooh, he nice.
Better wax swinging in the loose moves. Show me captivity, slavery.
We're doomed by Yahshua,
my king, my king.
We was looking for a way out. We was looking for a way out.
What the hell?
We was looking for a way out.
So this what they playing Dallas on New Moons?
Never waiting on a way out. We was looking for a way out.
Yo, I gotta find his brother's name, man. We gotta find his brother's
Sign
name.
Sign him to a record deal.
Yeah, your time is up. No more black body swinging.
She got flow. She got flow.
We gonna take back everything you stole. From the raw crescents to the trillions in gold.
She went Como D.
In the land and the whole darn earth. Our people dispersed, rulership on this earth. Now, don't try to run it, because you can't hide. Ain't no hold.
All right, that's enough.
What?
I have enough.
Hey, that thing.
Hey,
hard.
Give Dallas a hand, man. Dallas, man.
Dallas.
Dallas, y'all got it, man. No more challenges.
Benjavites got nothing on that. I don't know what y'all gonna do.
Y'all was talking about, bro.
RIP to the payback challenge.
Benjavite cannot even come close to that right there.
Yo, Benjavites fall back, man. I gotta be honest.
It's because they speech had fire.
That's fire, bro. That's fire right there.
Dylan.
Yo, Captain Isaac, bro, that's platinum. That's going to go platinum.
You're going to get a platinum.
That got to be on IUIC TV.
Yeah.
Next Passover, you getting a plaque.
Hey, sisters, what y'all think about that song, man? What y'all think? Was it fire or what?
Shoot, they need to take our spots.
Damn.
That was like a mix.
Yeah, you ain't got, don't worry, you ain't got no spot. It's cool.
Insane clown posse.
We appreciate y'all coming out.
Say what, sis?
We had an insane clown posse.
Damn, y'all look like, y'all look like the insane clown posse.
Give me the next one.
Repented. Now, let's see the real challenge. Let's take it to BK, man.
Let's go to New York challenge.
Let's go to New York, you know what I'm saying?
Fresh off the press.
Shout out to Officer Solomon.
And his wife, Amanda.
New York.
That's his wife.
I like
to take it to Brooklyn.
Hey, that's a muck, ain't it? Yo.
Mana.
Pay him back, pay him back, pay him back.
99.
Yo. They want to hear something heavy to make their head bob. Seeing the Lord and it's coming, make their knees drop. Venomous snakes, the change of state. All that harm they done, open up the Lord's floodgates. They dropping dead at a phenomenal rate. Ain't no escape except to fate. Apologies be too late. Even for good to pay, but pay them 10 times more. Vengeance will be the score, a punishment brought for. Blood spills on the floor, and it's up to the bridle. We reclaiming the title, our vengeance is homicidal. Finally the recital, and it's getting real tribal. Scriptures as subtitles while we rehearsing the Bible. Revenge tastes so sweet, sweet. They mad cause they saw they burnt right for a muscle of meat, meat, meat. They messing with Christ, sheep, sheep, sheep. Now we sing the light upon our beds as they kiss our feet. And they can quick and leap down. Turn their hearts to temper till they go and have beneath the ground. And break their bodies to shivers, to stand alone. Of our black God, don't make these nations
you know what's coming to
BK Judah.
BK Judah.
Man, that look like it. Man, that look like it.
I said the payback.
Yo.
Oh. Hit me.
Hey, before this blow down. Goodbye, Uncle Tom, your mom, and your patriots. Cause your men that fell and lost safety nets. F a football fist called forfeits. And more fits combined with raw hits. Enos either a raider or he's a buccaneer. He even changed the shade of the faces of the musketeers. He just peddled the ghetto, playing puppeteer, pulling our strings with bluffs. Now we're stuck with queers. No boys allowed, NBA, but Nambla enjoys that crowd because men be gay. The truth scares Paul, who was a fierce soul.
Thanks
for Stern, I learned how he fears all. Mighty God, but not Tidy Whitey Bob, who's more than slightly trite, everything in sight he robbed. With Spidey's mighted odds, it's still his nightly job. He likes to ignite fights and incite the mob. Kingslayer, who even sleeps with his sister, results are illegitimate, hear the peeps and whispers. Tangle webs he weaves, so we wig out. Entanglements were bred since Eve cleaved to his mouth. They set it off in Nick's pursuit of happiness. Willa Smith wakes to quick root the nastiness. Bombs swarm and horn claws, they call Becky. Don't be alarmed, they wreck rednecks directly. The devil rebel from peddling several booby traps. We were hated, they baited Jacob with Scooby snacks. Jinkies think we won't pick up the clues, but think these links inked into structure cues. The right Shemite won't flip for quick mammon. So I ain't sick, wildin' out, or Nick Cannon. Fake fraud, K-Zars, y'all full of ish. Cause real Jews been hewed from a dark mix. Tell Archie his poker will be getting blazed, according to the edict, but those were the days. Combative adages, songs and swords drawn are performed on the rabid and savages Babylon. Ooh, the unchaste daughter who sitteth upon lake shores. In many waters, this broad is the great hall. Esau's the beast to eat raw. When the fleet gets released, he's leased at Seesaw. They rose die snake, eyes die lake fried. They'll bake sigh and cry for their hate crimes.
Payback. Oh, that's right, y'all. This is a bit heavy. The payback. Oh yeah, Esau, you know what's coming for you. You know what's coming for you now. And listen, the payback.
Payback.
We ain't forgot about
all
y'all.
Great.
Too, man. Y'all gonna get y'all's too.
Solomon did his thing.
That's a good one. Hey, that was a nice one.
BK Judah.
It was creative.
That's very creative. Very creative.
Hey, shout out
Solomon to Solomon D. Sting, man. That's very creative.
So what do you think about Captain Isaac in Dallas?
Oh, God.
I don't know. That thing was hard,
That thing was bars, man.
That thing was hard, man.
According to Gad.
I can't believe they did that.
I don't know when the parody come out and it'd be better than you thought
it
was.
That, we need to know that brother's name.
Right.
Like, who is that brother?
Captain Isaac.
Oh, damn. So he was in the mask? Cap was in the mask?
I don't know. Was that a corona mask? What was the kind of mask?
Yeah, the new guy.
It was a masquerade mask.
Oh.
It's one you wear to a masquerade party.
Oh, we got a phone
call. Eyes wide shut.
That was Gad music, huh?
Let's take the phone call real quick. I know we're running out of time. Shalom, caller. What's your name, question, or comment?
I'm holding, but I want.
Shalom, caller. What's your name, question, or comment?
Shalom, leadership.
Shalom.
It's a comment, and this is Janine from the Miami camp. I just have a comment in regards to what Bishop was asking our sisters in regards to what happened with the little girl.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, go ahead, sis.
Growing up back home.
All right, go ahead, sis.
We growing up back home, we were never allowed to walk by ourselves. As young ladies, we always had to go in pairs of groups, or we always had to have an older sister or an older cousin male had to go if we were to go to any form of event. So one thing that could have been prevented, and I know it's traumatic for both the mother, and that's going to be something lasting also for the child. But these both, although they didn't know biblically a lot of the scriptures, I think we kind of understood what we were to, our parents taught us that you weren't allowed to do certain things. When you get older, you realize that it's somewhat scripture related.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, sis.
Thank you.
What she said is
so true. Because I be seeing that these little boys, these parents, you got a 10-year-old, a 9-year-old little kid walking down the street by themselves.
Right.
Going to school by themselves.
Yeah, going to school by themselves. And should not, especially in this country. Oh, my God.
You know what the sister said they were not allowed, she said back in her home country, the women were not allowed to walk alone. They had to pair up. You know, and that's what Genesis 34, can we read that? Genesis 34, verse 1 and 2. That's what the Bible says regarding Dinah.
Yep.
The book of Genesis, chapter 34, verse 1. And Dinah, the daughter of Leah, which she bare unto Jacob, went out to see the daughters of the land. And when Shechem, the son of Hamor, the Hivite, prince of the country, saw her, he took her and lay with her and defiled her.
That's what happens. So she was walking around. She should have been paired up. Somebody should have been with her.
She had 12 brothers.
Yeah, 12 brothers.
Right. And Bishop, you know, oh, I'm sorry, go ahead. You finished the scripture?
Yeah, that was it.
You know, when you get these big cities and like Dee said, little girls walking around by themselves, you see like, say, New York in the morning. Mm-hmm. You see all the little kids by themselves going to school, getting on subways, getting on buses all by themselves. That thing is dangerous, man. That thing is really
a serious issue,
man.
It is.
And it's feeding time for like predators on the streets.
Right.
I would say that kind of stuff make you understand and see why the Lord say that the daughters of Israel are princesses. Cause somebody should always be looking out for them.
That's right.
Like, I mean, from the time they with their daddy to they get to their husband. Somebody got to be looking out for him because this is vicious, bro.
Listen, what you said is so true, Kamala. Like, even in this, we in the truth right now, right? Your brothers, especially your brothers with daughters, pay close attention. Don't think because you're in the truth, certain things cannot happen. Take very close attention to your daughters.
Right.
Make sure you know where they're at all time. I'm telling you, all time. Let me go to so and so. No, sit you black behind here. You ain't going nowhere. I'm telling you.
Right.
Oh, can I go to so and so house?
Spend the night.
Spend the night. No. You cannot. No. Sit you black behind here. Go in your room. Spend the night in your damn room. Right. No, I'm serious.
Hell no.
These little girls, man, especially in this country, bro, they're fast.
Because spending the night always turned into some BS when you.
Yep. Especially where she going to spend the night. The brother or the sister might have little boys there.
Right.
No. Because in your mind, you might think, oh, yeah, that's the Israelite. Nothing going to happen. Okay, you keep taking that.
Right.
You keep taking that. The scripture talk about the evil of these kids.
Little boy got crawly fingers.
Mm-hmm.
Crawly fingers.
The scripture talk about that. And then you're going to be like, whoops, my bad. No.
I only missed and touched her. Nah.
That is, hey, you know, by the way, that is why the father have to be there. Mm-hmm. Because some of these sisters with these daughters, they have no clue.
No clue at all.
Yeah. They have no clue. You know, it's the fathers always say, no. My daughter's not going to go nowhere. Oh, well, you know, that's her friend. I don't give a damn that's her friend. She ain't going nowhere.
But we had some instances like that a few years back with some children and the mama's not watching. And next thing you know, you got to go through a whole what happened, what was this, why this little girl here with this little boy, and why he watching them, and why she, and where you was at. And, you know, you be like, man, ain't nobody got time for all
these brothers
got
to watch out, man, because sometimes these little girls, they're going to embarrass your guys as fathers. They're going to embarrass y'all.
come home with children.
Yeah, and that's what Tobit's daughter, I mean, not Tobit's daughter, Tobias, when he got married to Mariana, he said, I never brought shame on my father's house. Like, she was that kind of sister where she was like, none of these things that I do, you know what I'm saying? I don't understand why the Lord keep playing
me. Kamala, listen, even in IUIC, that's why I said, when I'm sitting on the table, when I sit on the table, leadership table, I see everything. I just don't say nothing. I see these sneaky-ass little girls around here, try to talk to little boys. I see little demons boys try to sneak around and talk to little girls. I'm sitting there, I'm looking at them.
Little demon.
Little demon. They are little demons. Demon, you just talk about that. So you fathers, listen, man, your job is to look out for these little girls, man. I'm telling you, they're fast.
Right.
Yeah. So tic-tac.
Is it tic-tac or tic-tac?
Who cares?
Tic-tac, but they're small.
Oh, damn.
Tic-tac.
Because they're small. Look at her. She look at me. Look at her. She look at me.
She was like, I ain't get a shot. I need a redo.
You better be pissed in the car on the way home, boy.
You didn't say nothing. You did up for us.
Where's the chemistry?
You supposed to be the chem
on
the street. Together we chemistry.
You didn't even want to go.
You chem on the street. So, sisters, what's going on, man?
It's over.
Look at it. They like it's over. So, hey, watch
fun.
This.
It's I fun. Think they gave
watch
up.
This,
man.
Watch this. No, they're not. Watch this. Hey, what's your name again?
Tick.
Abigail. Yes. Abigail. I'm just be honest with me. You think you're too fit for the show?
She said, "Hell no, girl. You don't."
She said, "She like she hit her leg on
let
Family
her talk,
Guy."
Man, let her talk. Let her talk.
I don't think so. I don't think it's a good idea.
Kim said.
It's what about you?
It's street.
That's talk.
Take on talk.
What about you? No. What's your real name again?
Ishe Shaya.
What do you think?
I think if we like had a shot and was on our own, kind of having our own chemistry, like we could do, like we can make something happen.
So this is the wrong platform for them to shine. They're saying. It's the wrong platform for them to.
You feel like y'all didn't get an opportunity really to showcase y'all being y'all. But the point is, to Captain's point, the point is to fit into the show that, like, with Deacon. So I don't know. It's kind of tough to that's the whole point of finding out if somebody's a good fit is to see if it's gonna work with the environment.
In every show, what I know about, you understand?
I didn't know Barnabas was here.
People always rehearse. You understand?
Yes, sir.
They know their chemistry, one on one. You understand? So.
Okay.
Their chemistry is like driving down the street at home. You understand one-on-one then?
You're saying so like off camera different than on camera?
Yeah. But
okay, this
camera,
is the thing.
You understand for real.
When you look at patient scent, you look at us that been doing it for a while, we have no script.
Right.
That's because we know each other. We have a chemistry.
Right.
That's, Kana, you just got here. Don't shake your head. When you look at us, we have a chemistry. Seriously, people think we have a script. People think we got script. Like we don't.
Yeah, like we put scripture.
Like the way we are, people, the way we like know each other, people think we actually go by a script. No, we don't.
Yeah.
We don't write nothing. We actually don't write nothing. We actually come and just...
It is what it is,
just
man.
Flow and just talk.
Hey, but Dick, it is tough, because I ain't going to lie. Like, when y'all first started letting the younger men come, like myself, Officer Carmella... It like even for me, it took a second to be like, yo, what can I say? What can I say? I don't want to get blasted about making a joke, the wrong jokes. So I could see how it could be intimidating to be in the atmosphere because they probably say things around each other that they are afraid to say in front of. You got Bishop
officer,
right here. They don't want to.
I told them that last night. I said we want somebody who's not afraid to speak their mind because listen. One thing about, when you look at, what that show with Whoopi Goldberg, The View.
Yeah.
When you look at The View, women always have some type of nonsense they want to say. That's what I'm looking for.
Yeah.
Deep, to their benefit. Deep. No, I'm serious. They always got some type of, you know, like, okay, you're talking about something.
An opinion, have an opinion.
Yes.
Right.
You're talking about something important. Here come the woman. She's like, hold
way
on.
Way up.
Let me put my little two senses.
Right.
Or the female perspective.
Yes.
Seriously? Not too snap.
Seriously? I want that.
I think they need more reps on the show. One show ain't going to dictate.
Why don't you have your own show and have their own rep?
Let me try to help this guy. He's trying to give him a workout.
Hold up. Listen on.
Like, what if we made our own video and auditioned that way?
Okay. I accept that.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Oh, y'all.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Tech team cold.
Hey, how you think I got this job? You think I got this job by sending in a video? No, I got on here and I said some BS. Deacon laughed and he said, bring them back.
Yeah.
That's what you got to do. You got to come on here, be yourself. If you can't do that,
you got to be yourself. I'm telling you. Yeah. Because the people online, they can tell if you're faking it or not. They can. We always tell the brothers, hey, listen, when you go to camp, you're teaching, you got to make it believe you believe what you're talking about.
Right,
the
right.
people that listen to you, they can tell, yo, this brother, he don't believe what he's teaching. Yeah, he's fake. The people online, we've been doing this for, we've been doing this for like 5 years now?
5 years.
Patient said you've been on 5 years. Listen, our brothers and sisters that's online, the reason they turn in is because they know we ain't faking.
Right.
We're going to, hey, Do we
rehearse?
Offended people every Sunday? Absolutely, yes. But we don't give a damn. We don't care.
You're funny. Okay, who get called?
We don't care.
Last Sunday.
We're not trying to be someone. We try to be ourselves.
Right.
That's what you got to do.
Have y'all ever seen yourselves on camera before?
No.
Okay.
I never heard myself on like recording, but not ever on.
Okay.
Well, this is going to be something new for you.
We actually, at my old apartment, we was watching, like, Wicked television. We was like, you know, what's going to, you know, let's make stuff up, you know, let's do something. And we kind of did that just on our own, kind of, just,
you know. Where all that was at today? You left it at the house
in the
apartment.
I think they're saying they said they want to try to, you know, make a video. All right. And see
Deeks are giving the okay to make a video.
Right.
Yeah, y'all guys can make a video.
I'm going to send y'all audition reel.
What you do? You scared of the bishop? That's why. I know people always try to be, but bishop is.
Brothers, what I say the right thing.
Right, let me put it like that. For the future people who's coming in this show.
Yeah.
As long as you're not disrespectful, be yourself.
Right.
Hey, at the end of the day.
At the end of the day, you got to be yourself.
The most you're going to do is get told you ain't. Like, yeah, you gotta go.
That's
like,
what I'm saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, like, yeah. You got the damn devil on you.
The same thing. Listen, the same result is going to happen if you don't be yourself and if you do be yourself and they don't like you. It, at least if you was yourself, you leave from it and you like, well, I left it all on the table. I was myself. But now, y'all gonna be biting y'all gonna be hitting
wondering
yourself.
What you could have did.
Yeah, y'all gonna be in a car like, damn, girl, we could have been our
shit. Actually, that's what I'm saying.
Now, Daniel, what do we want?
I think we should get a second opinion.
Second opinion from who?
I think we should ask the people. No.
You haven't seen the comments?
Have you seen the comments?
I would like to see the comments.
You would?
The comments say you're the worst host that ever had.
They said your sleight of hand had a hangnail.
Hey, this bloody talking. What? I'm in Facebook right now.
Israel, if y'all liked your boy Dan the Man, put a thumbs up in the comments.
Dan the Man.
Put a thumbs up in the comments and let Deacon know that you're
Deacon, he just cut you off, Deacon. I like Dan the Man.
Somebody. What the hell just happened?
If you guys want to vote for Dan the Man.
He just took your show, Deacon. He just cut you off. If you like your boy, Dan
the Man. I'm reading the comment right now. They don't like you, Daniel.
I promised to bring free lunches.
You should have let him wear that Moab shirt.
Did you see anything for him?
He getting some thumbs up. He got thumbs up.
Where? Where thumbs? I don't see no thumbs, Daniel.
He said, I don't see no thumbs.
Right. I can't believe it.
You getting thumbs up.
No thumbs.
Right? You getting thumbs up.
No.
Dan the
show
Man.
Show some love, like, Israel. That's what I'm talking about.
So if y'all like Daniel, keep the thumbs up going. If y'all don't like him,
by the way,
sisters,
sister that's online, if you want to come to Atlanta, be in the show, we're going to put you on too.
Show some love to
you. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
We're ready to move to Atlanta.
Show some love.
Daniel, two fingers.
Come on, bro.
You
want to
get two fingers. That's it.
Yo, show some love.
I think
to
the audition's gonna have to go on for a minute, maybe somebody like a couple weeks at the time.
Somebody say, ban the man.
Hey, you're going to have to run auditions for at least another 2 weeks, maybe at the Tabernacle, man.
Shout out to the homies,
man. Hey, we got to go. We got to go. What time it is?
Yes, 12.
Man, they say,
hey, we
got
to go.
All right, brothers, sisters, that's our show for today. Remember, we have a school here in Riverdale, Georgia, 691 Highway 138 in Riverdale. Come down, come learn, come get with these prophets, come get with these sisters. We have online classes 3 times a day, 7 days a week for absolutely free at IUIC Classrooms on Facebook and Israel United in Christ on Periscope. Donations, if you want to give to the body, you can do so via PayPal at iuic.atlanta@israelunite.org. If you want to give to the Booster Club, you can do so via PayPal also at iuic.fundraising@israelunite.org.
The brothers and sisters that make this possible, Officer Elijah, Officer Kidan, Officer
Nechamai.
Yeah, you know the lights in there, can I see? Officer Nechamai, Officer Zedaniah, Officer Malachi, Officer Adino, Officer Zaku, Soldier Matthias, Soldier Emmanuel, the lights, what in this thing, can I see? Breakfast. The sisters who provide breakfast for us this morning. Sister
Avaya
from House.
Officer
Yai. Sister Shimonia of House of Brother Benjamin. Thank you, thank you, thank you all. Brothers and sisters online, we thank you, thank you, thank you. Next, we got Deacon Aitan. That's it.
Our hidden history.
Yeah.
The Bible, our hidden history.
Our hidden history, Deacon Aitan. With that, Israel, we love you. Thank you, brothers and sisters online. We love you. Shalom.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.